Hello, right. Good evening, everybody. Can you all hear me? You people? Can you all hear me or what? Right, okay. I think your audio is muted. I can just see your faces. Right. So welcome all for the live session about the history optional. Welcome to Smart Leaders. I can see some of my old students. Abhi also is there. Okay, I can see him. Anyhow, welcome all of you to the Smart Leaders. There are a lot of students who are new to this to the platform. Okay, there are a lot of students who are new to this usage of this Zoom. Some of them are already aware of how to use this. So what I will tell is, it is very simple. I think you are coming, you can hear my audio, you can see my face and other things, and it is live in the Facebook also. For information, it is live, it is going live in the Facebook also. So you are all able to hear me, you can see my video, audio, everything is there. But I can see you. If you want to ask any question to me, there are two things which we can do. According to the Zoom, actually, there is an option which is called raise hand. You can go and click raise hand and all. We will not go all this. You just raise up your hand in the photo itself. I can see you. This is option number one. Or always there is a good option. Rather than that, there is something which is called a chat. I think you can see below chat option. Is it not? Chat. Everybody seeing. So if you want to ask any question to me, you can type the question and post. I will read the question and give an answer to all of the queries, etc. Okay. So that is what it is. So I am just going to begin. So just to make you familiarize, you can all hear me well. You can see me. Okay. If you want to ask any question, I'll speak very slowly. Okay. If you want to know anything, if you don't understand anything, go to this chat option and type the question. That is the first thing. Secondly, today I think I have asked Ms. Dharmalakshmi, IAS, who is our history optional topper, also to come here so that you can have what she has to say, etc. You can have her interactive session, etc. So ask her to come. She'll be joining very soon. So before she joins, I just wanted to give you some basics, okay? Basics about the history optional, basics about how things are going, etc. I will speak now. Okay, just a minute. I think some people are getting admitted now. Okay, just a minute. I think, yeah. Okay, we can do that. So that's how our session is going to go today. So first, there are people who are already taken history optionals. I can see a few face. There are people who do not know anything about history optionals. Okay, they have so many doubts amongst them. Okay, why we have to choose an optional? What is the reason why we have to choose an optional? That we have to be very clear. The reason why we have to choose an optional, let us be very clear about that. See, we choose an optional because it should help us to get IAS. Is it not? That is what everybody wants. They want either an IAS or IPS. They choose an optional. The optional should help them to score sufficient marks so that they can reach IAS. Is it not? That's what is the purpose of the optional. Secondly, that optional which you choose, you have to study without any difficulty. You have to have some familiarity with the optional. You have to have some familiarity with the optional which you are studying. It should not be Greek and Latin. It should not be something totally new. It should not be something which you have not heard ever in your life. So that optional should be slightly familiar to you. That is the second reason why we have to choose any optional. Third reason, when you choose an optional, you should have a mentor to guide you to the examination. You might have a good optional. You may have other aspects also. But without a mentor, you cannot update your preparation. Is it not? Without a mentor, you cannot bring that edge, the mark edge, which you say, you know, in the UPSC. Okay, edge means everybody, what they score, that also you will score, average mark. From the average mark, another 20-30 marks more in each and every paper, that we call it as an edge. That edge can be ensured only by a proper, a mentor or something. So you should have a proper mentor. Okay. And one more point about choosing an optional is that you should have a study group, a students. Other than the mentor, you should have some students with whom you can discuss, with whom you can compare the answers, etc. Okay, like this, there are many reasons how you have to choose an optional. So I'll just give you one or two points here because this session is not going to be a very long session. Okay, I want to ensure that the session is as brief as possible. Okay, first thing is that mark, scorability of the marks. You see, it has been told to you, I do not know, you should have met some of the students, senior students or something. They should have told you that the history optional is not mark fetching optional, is it not? You should have also heard one or two people telling, they say that you take this Tamil option, you take that option, X option, Y option, and this will get you so much marks. Okay, to disprove that fact only, I have asked Ms. Dharmasri to come. Okay, because she is our student, and you know how much she got in the history optional. She got 300 plus marks. You understand? She got 306 marks. And also we have Manoj Prabhakar, last year our history optional student, who is presently in IPS training. He is in Hyderabad now. I wanted to put him in this Zoom app, but I could not reach him. Maybe soon, maybe next time, within maybe in the next class, I will somehow try to integrate him to this history optional batch or something. Okay. So Manoj Prabhakar, he got 314 marks this year. Last year when it happened, 314 marks in history optional. When students are telling that, sir, 250-260 is a good mark for optional subject, I am telling 300 plus is possible. There is a live example here. And you are going to interact with Dharmasri. I will ensure that you speak to her. And she has not done anything, what to say, special. She is not even an history student, you must know. She has some technology, fashion technology she has studied. Manoj Prabhakar is an engineering student. They learnt history new only here. Okay, they learnt history new. And they have scored a tremendous mark. 300 plus in any optional subject is a very good mark, you must know. Is it not? And so, history is a scorable subject, provided you know what to read. You should not dump yourself with unnecessary information. The problem with history optional is that there are no proper mentors for this optional. You see, everybody in the North India, maybe I think there are some mentors. I'm not very certain about that. But in the South, there are totally not many people who can give you an insight into this history optional. Okay, so that is the reason why sometimes they load you with so much material. Sometimes they give you instructions which are redundant. So I think this puts you into a lot of confusion. Okay, so history optional, no doubt, is a scorable optional. It ensures that you will become an IAS. Example, Dharmasri. It ensures that it will become IPS. Example, Manoj Prabhakar is there. And also our history optional student, one more person, is a district collector, Mir Muhammad Ali. I should have put in some post or some Quora answer. I do not know whether you are reading my Quora answer regularly or not. I have put his post. Just a few days back, I wrote in Quora answer about meeting some of the old students. He was a district. Now he is a district collector presently. He shifted now from that Kannur district. So Mir Muhammad Ali is also my history optional student only. Are we understanding this? So history optional definitely is a scoring optional. You need not have to worry anything about, Okay. If you are totally dedicated, if you just follow simple instructions, and if you are an average student, I will ensure that you will get 300 plus in history. What are the criteria which is required? Average student. You have to follow the instructions which I give you. And you must be regular to the classes and follow what is that we say. That much would be sufficient. Are we understanding this? That much would be sufficient. So you need not have to bother much. You need not have to break your head. You need not have to read some complex jargons in history. The advantage in history is that you need not have to read any complex things. Everything you know about, already you have studied something about this. Okay, everything is known to you. You are not going to read any jargons or etc. So that is the point in history. Okay, so for one thing, is history is a scorable subject. Second, let us come to the point, what is called, whether this history syllabus can be complete. Can we complete the history syllabus? How much time you require to complete this history syllabus, etc. You see, normally, we require 4 months to complete the history syllabus. 4 months. Okay, every day you have to spend around two and a half hours. Okay, every day you have to spend two and a half hours. Just 1 minute, please. Just 1 minute, somebody is. Just 1 minute, please. Okay. Somebody has given recommend that the audio is low. You are all hearing properly first? Is audible? Okay, somebody has given a comment that the audio is low. Just 1 minute. I'm just looking into that. Right? Okay, let us come to the point. See, about the time period which is taken to complete this, I require just 4 months, you must know. Okay, just 4 months to complete. And every means every day around 2 hours at the maximum, I take classes just 2 hours. And 5 to 6 days in a week. That much, 5 to 6 days only in a week. So we will complete very easily. 4 months easily it can be done. And what are the topics which are going to cover? Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, World History. So approximately 15 to 20 days for each and every part. So which is roughly 60 days. So 60 days means adding to the Saturday, Sunday and all, it will roughly, I'm going to plan to around three and a half to 4 months. That's what I'm planning. So that's how we are going to do. So history option can be easily done in 4 months time. Plus you have to write the test which you have planned. The test is going to be around 20 tests we have planned. That 20 tests you have to write, that is very important. Okay. Secondly, whether this history as an optional, how useful it is. When you take any optional, it should not only help you to score marks. Of course, it is helping you to score marks. How useful it is for your preparation of other topics. Let us say for general studies, how useful it is going to be. You will all be knowing that in the general studies, history is a very important topic in general studies. I think everybody will accept it. History is a very important topic. Okay. In this general studies, if you see, ancient India, medieval India and modern India, from these areas, questions are asked in the preliminary examination. What are they? Ancient, medieval, modern India. So you have to study ancient India, medieval India, modern India for your preliminary. So even if you are not taking history as an optional, studying this ancient, medieval and modern is a compulsion for your GS paper. Not only that, ancient plus some part of medieval, culture topics are asked. Not only in the preliminary, in the mains also culture topics are asked. So you cannot neglect this ancient or medieval and study only modern or something like that. Because in the preliminary, I should have mentioned that in my free classes, if you attended my free classes, you will know that in the preliminary, about 20% of the questions, they come from the history. Okay, last year around 18 questions out of 100 general studies questions had purely come from the history only. So you have to just keep that in the mind that 20 questions in the preliminary, they come from the history. So ancient, medieval, modern, you have to read for the preliminary. History optional also, ancient, medieval and modern is only there. You understand that? Next point, if you see, there is a topic in the history which is called world history. I told you, that is a world history. The world history is given as a compulsory topic for general studies mains paper. If you see the general studies paper 1, GS mains paper, if you see, world history is a compulsory topic. Is it not? So, even if you do not take history as an optional, you are already reading ancient India, medieval India, modern India and world history. So you are already reading the whole history syllabus only. Nothing more, nothing less. But the depth only slightly it will vary. If you are taking history as an optional, you have to read slightly in a deeper level. That's it. Slightly in a deeper level. And I would say that for your information, I would say if you are a general studies student, if you have read your history properly in general studies, that is ancient, medieval, modern plus world history, if you attempt the history optional question paper, mains question paper, easily you will get around 220 to 240 marks. Without any preparation, even a general studies student can easily score. So, whatever knowledge you are having with general studies, that itself is already guaranteeing you 220 to 240 marks in history. Please understand that. With me, I will ensure that you will get the additional 60 to 80 marks that we have to do. For the 60 to 80 marks, how much deep you have to read, that we will discuss. Okay? In the classes, whatever it is, I will give a second line of information, second evidences, etc. That we can do. It is not an issue for us. Okay? So that is the point. So history is going to help you in your general studies preliminary. If you are a history optional student, no need to read for general studies preliminary. 20% questions are guaranteed for you. Mains, one paper, almost 50 to 60% of paper 1, which is the world history, Indian culture, modern India, personalities in general studies paper and GS paper 1 in the mains is history related issues. So that also you need not have to bother. Secondly, SCA topic, if you come to the SCA, which is again a GS paper, in the SCA, compulsorily one question will be history oriented question. It will be about Gandhi. It will be about a quote given by Vivekananda. You understand this? So this history is going to help you. And also please understand, I am telling that directly history is going to help you in general studies, paper one, and in SCA paper. But history is also going to help you by giving a 20% advantage in paper 2, 3, and 4. Because if you have historical background well, if you only have historical background well, you can understand all the topics in the general studies. You tell me any international topic, any current affairs topic, without the historical background, can you understand that? You tell me, please. You need an historical background. Even for example, today, we have just in the newspaper today morning, I was seeing that the Nepal government, the constitution, they are planning to have a second constitutional amendment about creating a new map. Is it not? So you have to know the background. It is a current affairs topic only, no doubt. But you have to know the background. What is the relation between Nepal and India? When the map was drawn? What is the issue about the Kalapani region? Is it not? Then Lepuleka Pass is there. What is that issue? That you have to know. So if you know history, already 20-25% of our preparation is done. Thirdly, if you see any issue, not only international, any issue, if you have an historical background, your idea, your opinion can be a 360 degree opinion. You are not going to give a partial opinion or a biased opinion. For example, the issue of OBC reservation. Is it not? That is a live issue. Recently, the government, just 1 year back, the government had introduced a reservation for economically backward. Is it not? In the forward community who are there economically backward, based on economy, reservation is opened. Is it not? But the constitution, did the constitution allow? Why the issue of reservation had been introduced in the constitution? What is this reservation? What is this OBC? Why reservation has to be given? In the 2000 years, if you study of the history of India, you will understand whether reservation is given, needed, or whether reservation is a waste. How long reservation be given? Is it the only solution? All this can be understood by you very clearly only if you have the background in history. So history is going to help you in understanding the background also. Are we understanding this? Next, if you see in the interview, if you go to the interview board, if you go to the interview board also, if you are a history optional student, your approach to any question asked in the interview will be deeper. Because if a question is asked to you about the recent Indo-China, tell something about the relation between Indo and China. Do you think that India is going to emerge as a superpower in Asia, beating China? Let us say the interviewer puts a question, do you think that in another 20 years, do you foresee that India is going to become a superpower in Asia, surpassing China? What are the issues here? Is it not? They may ask this question. So you will be knowing current affairs. You will know trade. You will know, you will have the data trade in your hand. You will know recent agreements signed between India and China. You will know recent issues. But without understanding the background of the issue, in the interview, your answer will not be deep. It will be only shallow answer. Your answer will not be very deep. It will be only shallow. Are you understanding? It will be without much insight. So in interview also, to give a clear opinion, a clear, deep, insightful opinion, historical background, historical knowledge is essential. So this history option is going to help you. Okay, the history option is going to help you in every aspect of this. You understand why history is needed? And one more thing, don't you forget, when you go and work as an IAS officer, when you go and work as Indian Foreign Service officer, when you go and work as a revenue, if you're going and working as a police service, your knowledge in history is going to help you. An history knowledge person is always a powerful person, okay? Because he knows the data, he knows the facts. Nobody can easily take him for granted. Is it not? Can somebody come and give a story to you about Gandhi, which did not happen in history? Already many people, those people who are educated also do not know what is the difference between history and mythology. Which is history, which is mythology? what is called mythology, what is called history, what is the difference between these two, which is real, which is original, whether history is a science or is it an art, whether history is just a story or whether history has got some background. To understand all this, I think the knowledge in history is very much essential. So studying history optional is going to give you all the background about it. So I have explained to you how history optional is going to be a scoring optional. I explained to you how history optional can be completed in 3.5 to 4 months time here. How history optional is going to help you in the GS paper, general studies paper. You understand this? This I have highlighted. Next, I am going to tell to you, if you take history as an optional, you understand? So what materials you have to read? Should you have to remember all data? Should you have to remember all, let us say, the data from, you have to remember from 1st century, January 1, 1st century, what happened? On the January 2nd, what happened 2000 years back? By 11 o'clock, what happened? By 12 o'clock, is it what? People are telling me, sir, how can you remember all this? I am telling, who can remember all this? Even a supercomputer can't remember, I am thinking. Is it not? So what they will ask in the history, in the name of facts, they will ask you the revolt of 1857. I hope everybody knows the revolt of 1857. So just I am taking one small example. In the revolt of 1857, I hope in India there is called a Sipahi mutiny sometimes. Sometimes they call it the first war of Indian independence. Sometimes it is simply referred as the revolt in 1857. What they will ask simply, who are the leaders of the revolt? They may ask, correct? In the TNPSC, in the group service examinations, if you study, who are the leaders of the revolt? They will give choices. Who among them the following is not a leader of the revolt? Or who among the following is the leaders of the revolt? They may ask the question. I can accept this. Sometimes they may go one step further. They can ask, which leader acted in which place? For example, in Delhi, who was the leader? In Kanpur, who was the leader? In Jhansi, who was the leader? Jhansi was the leader. Jhansi, Rani Lakshmibai. Everybody knows this, is it not? Call this Jhansi Rani Lakshmibai. Who is the Mughal emperor? Who was the Mughal emperor by this time? Bahadur Shah Jafar. So they can go and ask this question. So you have to remember this fact, no doubt. As an history optional student, you have to know why the revolt happened, why the revolt came to an end. Was this revolt a successful revolt or was it a failure? If it is a successful revolt, why? If it is a failure, why it became a failure? Okay, that's it. You are not supposed to remember everything. But one thing is certain, in history optional, they are not going to ask you to give the names of all the soldiers who died in the revolt of 1857. Can they ask you? You tell me. Will they ask you to tell who among the soldiers who died? How many soldiers died? You are telling, sir, 2000 soldiers died. Tell the names of all the soldiers. What is their date of birth? Which is their native place? Will they ask all these questions? No. Nobody will ask. Not even TNPSC or any state public service will ask this. Is it not? History means only significant data you have to remember. Not all data. What is the significant data? That we will tell you in the class over a period of our experience. We know what is the significant data. Is it not? What is the significant data? We know. So we are going to just give you that information which is significant. Only that you remember. Don't you try to remember all the information. It is not necessary. In the name of studying for history optional, some students are being misled. They are misled. What are they doing? They are going and buying a big guide. I don't want to name the guides here. Their guide has got, in the first chapter, the guide has got something which is called chronology they have. What is this chronology? Chronology means from year wise, what happened, they are giving the dates. Some guides, if you see, they have so much dates, so much information, some guides, that from the first century, they are just having chronology, 100 pages they are having. I had seen a guide, only chronology, 100 page. What happened year-wise, 100 page. And seeing that, history students, they think that, oh my God, this is over. This is not my bread and butter. Is it not? Nobody needs to know all this. Nothing doing. I even do not know for information. Even myself, I don't know all this chronology. I have been studying history optional for a very long time. Even I do not know chronology. Just 1 minute, please. So you're all able to hear me, please? Somebody raise up your hand. I can see some of the photos here. Everybody? Yeah, there is some connection here, some issue with the connection. Okay, right. So I was telling about remembering the facts, remembering the data. Nothing to worry. The UPSC doesn't want you to be a supercomputer. A supercomputer can remember more data than you. If they want only you to remember all the data, they will better buy a computer instead of an IAS officer. You are not supposed to remember all the data. You have to know some data. Definitely, you have to know some data. Even for general studies, you have to know some data. Is it not? Some data you have to know for general studies also. So if you're studying an optional, some data is required. Some minimum data is required. What is more important than the data is how you process the data. Keeping one information, how you justify one point, when you're taking any opinion, how you are comparing this opinion. Based on these points only, the fact is important based on how you use the data only. Okay? So nothing to worry about the data. So that is one issue. Okay? So we began our discussion by what? There are some people who are entering only now in this chat session. So we began our discussion by what? I told you, what is this ST optional, whether the ST optional is mark fetching or not. Is it not? I told you second, how many months is required to complete the ST optional. Third, I told you about whether the ST optional is, how it is going to help you in GS, in the preliminary, in the mains, in the interview, in understanding the current affairs and other things. How this ST optional is going to help you, that we have spoken as a third. Now fourth, I told you about remembering the data. Is it not remembering the facts, etc.? Okay, so that also we are. Now fifth point, what we are going to do. In the fifth point is that I told you that learning history is a technique. It is an art. History is not simply memorizing of all the data. It is not simply mugging up of facts. Okay, it is not going to help you. You try 100 times, maybe one day you remember data, after 1 week you are forgetting everything. To learn history, there is a method. Okay, history has to be learned in an interesting way, in a step-by-step way only history has to be learned. It should not be suddenly learned, okay, as a memory or the data or something. You understand? So there is a technique of how to teach history. If you have to learn history, there should be a technique of how to teach history. Is it not? So I think over a period of time, we have developed a technique. I have developed a technique. I have been teaching history for close to 12 years. Okay, in 2007-8, I began my teaching. So I have been teaching history. So I have ensured that all my students understood history. Okay, to some extent, that much the UPSC requires. I am not going to make you all PhD scholars in history. Please, you understand, that is not the intention of us. I don't want you to become PhD scholar and not get IAS. You want IAS or PhD scholar? You tell me. You have to decide any of this. Many students here come to teach history to me, not learn history from me. That is one problem. They learn something from the book, they bring and try to teach me. Of course, I am interested to learn. What is the advantage you have got in this? Is it not? You are coming here, choosing history as an optional, so that you want to become IAS or IPS. Okay, only learn that much history, which is going to help you. If you learn too much also, that is also a problem. If you learn too much, more than what is required for this examination also, it is going to create unnecessary confusion. How it will create confusion? When you wanted to write an ending, when you wanted to give a conclusion, five conclusions will come to you. Five opinions will come to you. You wanted to write about Gandhi. You wanted to write about non-cooperation movement. You read four books, four authors with four different opinions. How are you going to write? What are you going to speak about these four opinions, four authors? So this is going to be a confusion to you. So don't you bother. You understand? What is the opinion? Everything we will take care. Okay, you don't need to read more. It is not necessary. Okay, to read more. So here what we will do is, here we have devised a method of teaching wherein which you can easily learn the subject. Okay, very easily you can learn the subject. Secondly, and the sixth point which I tell is the material. You see, I suggest my students for history optional to buy very less material. Even the GS material which you have, that is sufficient for history optional. I am not suggesting my history students to buy any other book. You will be surprised. Many people, they studied in Delhi, they came here and saw, sir, what, you are not recommending any book? No, nothing, no book is needed. Only GS book, whatever you are reading, I will tell you how to read the book, that you read properly. Secondly, my classes. you have to attend all my 60 or 70 classes. It is a must. Each and every class is an elaboration or depth of information about the basic topics. When I take, for example, one topic, let us say Indus Valley Civilization, if I take one topic, I'll speak one day on that topic. Okay, I'll tell you all the aspects about the Indus Valley Civilization, and I have learned from most of the books. I do not want you to do that research, because I have spent around how many, so many years, 15 years and more I have spent in reading history. I have done all the work. You don't bother. You just write down what I tell you. So the class I will teach, you write. Is it not? That will be sufficient. Plus, sir, any additional material? Yeah. For history optional, I give you material. For ancient India, one material I'll give you. Medieval India, one material. Modern world, I'll give material. That's it. You need not have to buy any books other than the NCRTs. Okay, some students are book hungry. Some students are content hungry. For them, I will suggest one additional book as a reference material. That also. As a reference material only. That also you need not have to mug up. Okay, so like that, based on your requirement, based on your skill, I will suggest a few books. Okay, that also is not a must. Okay, fundamental books will be sufficient. Fundamental books will be necessary. Fundamental books will be sufficient to clear this examination. Just my notes will be sufficient, plus basic NCRT books. If you want additional information, which of course I will give in the class itself, in the test batches I used to give this additional information. If you want more information, I suggest some books. For ancient India, I may suggest one reference book, medieval one, modern one, world history. That will be sufficient. That's it. This is the study material. So I have covered 6 points. Then the last 7th point is, sir, when you study any optional, you have to discuss and learn. You have to discuss and learn. You should not be isolated. In sitting in Chennai, definitely you should not be studying Pali literature. There is a paper which is called Pali. I hope you all know language paper, Pali literature. That is an optional. Sitting in Chennai, can you read this Pali literature? You tell me. You'll be isolated. You need your answers to be seen by a mentor. You need at least a few friends to discuss these answers. Is it not? So here I am totally available to you. Totally I am dedicated for the civil services. I have no other work. I have no other thing other than what to say. Mentoring the civil service students. I am fully available here. Secondly, here we have quality students also. Chennai is a well-developed hub for civil services. It is a well-developed hub. After Delhi, I think Chennai is emerging as the second important destination, bypassing even Hyderabad and Trivandrum or something, Bangalore, Trivandrum, all these centers. You understand? So here we have a substantial strength of the students with whom you can compete, with whom you can discuss and learn. Okay? So this is what is about history. Why you have to choose history? This I told you. This is a fundamental. You understand this? Okay. This is what basic information I wanted to give you. Okay. You have any question, you please type it. I'm ready to answer any questions which you have. You can type it in the chat box is there. You can type. Okay. So you can constantly type on some questions also. Before that, let me see if Ms. Dharmala has come. Okay. So Dharmala Sri is our student. She has studied here. From the first day to the last, she completed all her preparation here only in the Smart Leaders. She took history as an optional. She attended all my classes. Okay. And as I told you, she got very high marks in the history. Now she is IAS. Okay. She has just completed the phase one of her training. Just last week she came down. She is posted. Her cadre is Kerala cadre. She is posted in Kerala. Okay. Soon she will be joining in Palakkad as the assistant trainee collector. Okay, sub-collector, I think she'll be joining there in Palakkad in Kerala. Presently, she is, in Trivandrum. So, I think if you have any questions, you can ask to Ms. Dharmala Sri. You can ask to me also. Okay, we are here to openly help you. Feel free. Okay, now what I am going to do is I will, Ms. Dharmala has already come. I think she is attending the session also. So, she will give you an outline about some issues. Okay. Map reading, somebody has asked a question about map reading. Before Dharmala speaks, let me just give 2 minutes about the map reading. Sir, what about the map reading? Your map reading book is enough, sir. Yeah, I have published one map reading book. If you go to Smart Leaders, if you go to the website, if you go to Amazon, there is a book which is called Map Reading. Okay, so you'll be surprised to know that book, one part of the book, some content of the book was prepared by Ms. Dharmala herself also. She is present here. Okay, because I ensured that the students also put their mind and energy into the preparation and content, etc. So that map book is a compilation of many of my students, including myself. Okay, I compiled all this, but I gave an orientation. Map marking is done by one of my another senior student, Mr. Gopi. Okay, so I'll ensure that they also become a part, they learn. Okay, so some locations are prepared by Ms. Dharmala herself. So the map, you need not have to worry about the map. I will take care of the map. That is one map reading is there. One additional thing, that is nothing to do. Okay, 1 week, I will teach you how to mark the map. Every day, you have to remember some locations. I will give you exercise. From the day of you joining the history optional, I will give you some map reading exercise. It can be easily done. Nothing to worry about that. Right? So if you have any questions, you can put it in the chat box simultaneously. Also, somebody has asked the question, when history class will start and how about materials? Sir, all materials I will give you. Class will start in the 6th I have given. In the background, you can see, I don't know whether you can see the background. Okay? In the background, 6th, it is given. 6th June. 6th June, I am having a free session again. A live session, free session I am going to conduct. I will teach the class. Okay? I will teach, I will take one topic and I will speak to you, communicate to you in live session. Okay? 2 days, 6th and 7th, 2 days I will meet you. Live, free session I will meet you. If you want to register, you can register now itself. Okay, for the live session, you need not have to register. For optional registration, you can register. Now itself, it is not an issue. So 6th and 7th, 2 days, we'll have live session. Okay, it will be in your YouTube channel, you can see. Okay, so nothing to worry. If you have any doubts also, you can ask me. I think it is audible what I am speaking. Is it audible? Everybody, you can all hear me well? Loud and clear? Everybody, yeah. Right. So now Dharmala is there. I think Dharmala will answer some questions. Okay. Yeah, Dharmala, you start. I'm just going to listen. Okay. Welcome, Ms. Dharmala. Please, everybody, welcome Dharmala. She can. Okay. She is present here. And if possible, I think the person who is posting the video, you can show Dharmala's face a bit clearer so that others also. Yeah. Yeah, Dharmala, you begin. You start.
You can put speaker's view, sir. It will be better.
Speaker view, huh?
Speaker view putting na.
Chivandar, she has come.
Okay. Okay. Fine.
Is it?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, super. Give an introduction about yourself. You give an introduction about yourself. Tell how you come for the civil service preparation, why you chose a BST optional, how did you struggle, how you end up getting IAS. Okay, what are the materials you read? What are you doing right now? So just give an outline. Okay, frank talk.
Sir, ellarume Tamil la mixed group anda mari edha
irukku. It will be mixed. You can Tamil also plus English also, mostly English, because I think people have registered from online. I do not know many of the students who are seeing the classes.
Okay.
Some people are saying Tamil. Anybody don't understand Tamil, just type it in the chat session. Anybody don't understand Tamil? Tamil.
No, if Tamil vandute irukke. If you don't understand Tamil, just tell. Okay. I thought konjam apdi manasu vittu pesalam appdi nenachen.
Both English.
Okay, we'll go to English. No issues.
Tamil and English both, you can Tanglish.
sure. Can you hear me? Am I audible? Can you hear me? Okay, fine. So na peru Dharmala, that power star Kishan, is it okay? I'm Dharmala and I'm from Salem actually, and I did my BTech in textile cum fashion technology, and I worked for some 2 years in Bangalore, and then I came to preparation. Is it okay?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so I came to Chennai for preparation and I joined Smart Leaders and I completed in Smart Leaders. Nowhere else I went. Okay, maybe for some money I went to government institute during my interview time, I mean for mock interview just twice, and maybe for getting stipend I went to ADR. I mean, these are the things I went for other institute. I never gone outside of Smart for any purpose. Okay, whether it is my TNPSC or UPSC, anything, I didn't go out. I joined Smart Leaders and I know that I will take history, and I took history. That too from Sadiq sir. That is very clear. Okay, so I joined in 2014. This is my 5th attempt, I clear. And in my second interview, second means it was okay. And first time I cleared my prelims in third attempt, and I traveled. I went to till interview. Some nearest marks, I missed the entire thing. I didn't get any service. And then fourth prelims washout, and then again coming back, and fifth prelims, mains interview, everything is over. And this time I got 153 and 152 in my paper one and 153 in my paper two. So it's a decent mark. 305 in history is a very decent mark. I want to say this, I got 305 without any extra materials, without anything apart from sir's notes or sir's book. Okay, whatever sir teaches, I didn't read any author books. Okay, my material is very simple, and I attend the classes, and I got the materials, and I walked out, and I attend the test discussions. That's it. Okay, so can you hear me? Can you all hear me? Is internet is working good?
No, it's working good, ma. Continue, ma.
Okay, sir. This is my simple tip for history optional. First thing, why we want to take history optional, though sir has spoken much, I just want to say few things. Maybe you know that it may be useful for prelims because more than 15 to 20 questions have started coming from history, and that too in a not comfortable area. So we can use history optional. If we master an history optional, prelims is a cakewalk, you know. Almost 10%, near to 10%, 5 to 10% of the total people getting selected every year are from history optional. And, you know, in my batch, right from Chitra Mishra to me, or even to the next level, I mean, Indian Postal Service or Foreign Service, Vikram, or many people selected only on the history optional as a basis, okay. And I got IAS only because of history, nothing else, okay. I am in service because of history. 305 that mark, and I got IAS only because of this history option. Okay, other things and all, I got, you know, it is not a temporary one. I worked for optional, and it gave me other fruit actually. Okay, so the first thing I want to say is that, okay, for prelims, you know, definitely some questions will come, and for prelims, you people, can you hear me? Okay. So for prelims, you people might have studied modern India and as well as some part of ancient and medieval history. So almost 1/3 of the history syllabus you covered right from the prelim stage itself. Okay. The second part is about mains. In the mains part, I mean, for optional, you need to study only the world history extra and writing practice. Am I clear? So this is like a low hanging fruit. If you take history as an optional, it is like your smooth walk into the history optional mains and as well as GS1. And in one of my first mains, I got GS1 129 because of history optional. Okay, there were some 5 to 7 questions from history. I'm saying you're talking about 2016 GS1. Okay, so 5 to 6 questions from history, I mean world history and modern India in GS1. And it helped me to crack 129. That was the second top highest mark in GS. Okay, so this is like you can crack prelims. You can crack forest cutoff also, forest exam cutoff also, without any stuck. It's like effortlessly you can get. And then I'm saying that apart from history optional, you can very well get with the source notes, you can very well get from 300 to 310 or 320, you can get easily. I mean, without your own work, if you do whatever sir says, if you just follow, I'm guaranteeing you that, because I got that mark. Okay, without my own effort, I got 305. You can go up to 320 without any effort. Plus GS also, you can improve your score. Straightly you can get some few 20 to 30 marks in GS1. Okay, without any effort. 20 to 30 marks in one paper, 30 marks means 300 ranks. Okay, if I got 30 marks extra, I would have been in top 100. Can you get me? Fine. Then GS2, if you want to know about IR or any other, I mean, political science related topics or governance topics also, if you know history, if you know Arthashastra, if you know the history of the international relations, it will be very easy for writing the whole picture. This is an indirect benefit of being in history optional. Okay. And with respect to economy also, economic history and how this internal security issues also, if you know the post-Indian era, it will be helpful. Okay. And GS4, Indian ethics part, it's completely from the philosophy school. Okay, schools of thoughts, philosophies like Advaita, and all other Charvaka school of histories, no, Buddhism, Jainism, you can quote, and you can use the Gandhian principles in ethics. Okay, these are like directly you can take from history option and you can apply. Okay, the respective interview, I need not anytime. History is like your low-hanging fruit. You can take one point from here, one point from here, and you can fit it, and you can convince the opinions, convince your own opinions in the panel. Okay, so this is like a direct benefit of being an history optional. And coming to the next points, I mean indirect points, being an history optional, you know how to frame a subject. I mean, this is like not only a fact subject, okay? So this is more about analytical point of view. So if you know this analysis done, how to do the analysis, it will be very easy to frame an answer. I mean, I'm getting the structure of every answers because I started developing the structures in my optional. It was basically developed and corrected by sir. Okay. And linking the analysis with the facts. That is also the second aspect in structuring the main answers. Okay. So this is a main benefit of being in a history optional. And third one, like unlike any other subjects, it's very comfortable for us because we are very familiar with this subject right from our prelims days, and we know that it is nothing new. Okay, this is already a thing which has happened. Okay, so we need not to connect with the present, the current affairs. It is not so dynamic also. Syllabus is very clear, and you just want to as the syllabus is very clear, you want to take the notes for the syllabus words. Because even in, for example, in Indus Valley Civilization, you can have the subtitles, subheadings, and under that you can make some notes. This is how sir is to say. So if you make some few points only to the exam point of view, it will be very easy. Okay. And the next point is, can you all able to hear me?
Yeah, go ahead.
So next thing is about, if you know the subject, it's just very familiar, and if you're very comfortable, you need not to put yourself too much into the subject, even though it gives you 500 marks. Okay, you can equally spend time on your GS and ethics and other subjects. You can work it on. Okay, can you get me?
Yeah.
Fine. And for ancient India or medieval India, even for any other, including world history, materials are available, and don't worry about the hoarding of materials. Every institute will say what's one material, and they'll try to sell their materials. Okay. Every institute want to make some money out of the books which they are printing. Okay. So don't worry about the depth of materials, or don't worry about which books, ignore books, they'll say, or Upinder Singh, Romila Thapar books, they'll say continuously. But I'm saying that just follow NCRT. This is how sir taught us. You just follow NCRT books. First finish the basic NCRT books. And then anyway, you will sit in the sir's class. Okay, you will take the sir's class notes. Okay. And third thing is about, he will give the materials for the thing which is absent in the NCRTs and the class notes. Okay, some printed material, or he will discuss in the test discussions or in class. Okay. And he will have some of his books, it's like a facts, and how he told about the map book and all, we worked it out, and even we corrected also. So this is more than enough for history option, which is very less. I can say with this much of books you can get 300 marks. Okay, nothing much. Fine. So don't worry about the author books and all. They will say D.K. Jain, so many authors, Norman Lowy also. I never read Norman Lowy also. I just want to be very frank. I never read any author books for any sort of questions. Even though I bought one Upinder Singh book and Satish Chandra book. That's it. I mean, Bipin Chandra books, three books. I didn't complete, to be frank. Okay, but because we are not able to complete it in a given time. All we want is to manage the answers for the exam. Okay, and the managing answer should be factual and analytical. It should be interpreted to the questions and relevant to the questions. and it should certainly give the marks we wanted. Okay, that's it. So that art we can learn in SIRS class. Okay, I'll just say, for prelims and prelims class and all the SIRS class, how it will be full of fun. And he will say how to connect the facts with how to link the facts. There will be some different links and how he will narrate the entire story. Okay. And even for mains, he will start from, he's having a good chronological link. If he starts from French Revolution, he will stop it in this Corona crisis. Okay, this is how sir will link the subjects, because for many aspirants, they don't know how to link, they don't know how to start the world history from where. Okay, they will go to the Renaissance period or 12th century, 13th century, they will go on, they will get stuck. Or they will somewhere stuck in French philosophers itself. Okay, and they will miss out the main part of this World War things or other areas. Okay, you get me? So this thing also, sir will correct it out in class. And third thing, we should not miss SIRS class, because I will not miss, 99.9% I attended SIRS class. I will not miss class. First thing is that we will be much more depressed during our preparation, frankly. So his class will be humorous. So that is guaranteed one. And we'll get motivated and energized also, second thing. And third thing, how he takes the, how he discusses the answers or how he takes the class, no? It will be more organized way. In a more organized way, how he speaks, he'll logically convince the points one by one. He'll not allow us to, even during the brain, we can able to organize the points structure wise. Okay, this is how I was tuned. Okay, from a girl, from a girl from garment industry or even from tattoo area like Salem. Or even I can say I am from a village. Okay. So Karadipatti is my village. From that place I was able to do, even today, it was because of sir. So not only in our answer writing, maybe in our personality also, it influences a lot. Okay. It's a very frank opinion, because I was molded. I used to say, whenever I am seeing that pot thing in Smart Leaders, I used to say I was like a raw clay and I was molded completely in the Smart Leaders only. Okay, so this is not to sell Smart Leaders. I am saying that I was benefited, but I am saying what happened here. So this is very genuine and committed also, because I can knock the door of sir even at 12 o'clock. With my friends, two or three people, we used to sit in front of sir's table and we'll get the papers corrected. This happened in 2016 to 2018 continuously. I mean, every week we used to sit till night and we'll get the papers done corrected. Okay, and sir will discuss with answers also. Every individual answers he will discuss, and he used to spend some time for almost 30 minutes to 1 hour for each paper. Just imagine who is correcting all the papers individually and giving one-to-one feedback at this place. Okay, so you just think about his commitment also. And second thing, he will not allow us to go back to our places, even though he will help us continuously. So maybe because of sir, I got into service. Maybe that's actually true. After my fourth attempt, I was supposed to go back, because I didn't clear prelims itself. I was supposed to go back to my home, and only because of sir, I was retained some more during this work or that work or something. So I was completely engaged in preparation. So he said to that, and he committed me to clear the exam. The 305 entire credit to sir. Okay. So is there any questions regarding map? Don't worry about the map. Right from the grid lines, sir will start. Okay. So how to mark the grid lines and what are the sites? Repetition of sites. The frequency of sites asked in the UPSC questions. Almost for 20 sites, we can able to crack 16 or 17 just because we are attending his class. And the notes for important lines and facts. Okay, so if we put some more effort, we can crack up to 19. One or two is maybe tough points or something like that. Okay, but certainty of 19 questions, it is possible. And just 19 into 2.5, even if you miss, I missed one site. I was collapsed in map last time. I mean, during my first mains, I got just 100 marks in paper one, just because I collapsed my map, because I want to I want to excel in map, because I just aim like that. 20 out of 20, I want to get it done. But I couldn't go beyond 14 and 15 because my mindset was also not good. Because I want to excel all the 20. If I don't know one thing, I started like confused and collapsed in the exam hall. It further deteriorated my answers in the entire paper one. So I just got 100. I missed the service that time because of 3 marks. One map set. Can you clear? If I...
Go ahead, Ma. Dharmila, kya kya kya. Hello? Is it audible, please? Hello, is it audible? Is it audible what I'm speaking? What happened to Dharmila?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
Yeah, yeah, go ahead, ma. Suddenly you're
I don't know
why. Yeah, continue, ma.
So just because of one map set, I lost the service that time, maybe. Okay, so this is how the importance of optional, including map, and right from the prelims to interview. And even you can shape your personality also in the subject. And it is actually comfortable for all. Even if you have taken any humanities subjects or commerce background, doctors, and even like us engineers, you can take this as a subject and you can very well top in this subject without any difficulty. Okay, you can your entire preparation or not, the other way you read history. And it helps us to return in the same optional mode. Okay. Is there any doubts you can ask me? If you want to say something also, you can ask me.
Either you can type, you can send a chat message, or you can directly ask the question also. Chat message will be fine because if you open up the audio, I think everybody will make, for 20 people will also ask the same question. So it is better you type that. Even if you can't type or some issue, just raise up your hand. Maybe we'll unmute your audio. Okay? So maybe you can ask the question. Anybody, just raise up your hand. We'll unmute your audio. Yeah. Somebody? There's Aravind. Aravind, ask for. Yeah, go ahead, Arvind. Ask something.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Arvind, ask the question either to me or Dharmila.
Dharmila, ma'am, sir.
Yeah, Dharmila, please.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, Arvind.
Ma'am, I saw you all your videos, ma'am. Ma'am, I just want to ask.
Okay.
What are the mistakes that you done in the previous attempts, and what makes you achieve?
Okay, I didn't clear first two attempts. Okay, it was my first attempt. I took a mistake. I started in the April 2014, and I gave my prelims in August without studying. I mean, without even completing the NCERT. That time, one of my friend completed NCERT, and that time he got service also. Okay.
Okay.
So I think power has gone. It may come. Okay. And the second thing is about second attempt, I missed one question in my prelims and it took one more year. And the third attempt, I was all set for prelims. Okay, before going to the third attempt, I know that this year I'll clear prelims. Because I put so many efforts to clear the prelims, okay, that year. But I was not ready for my mains. That is the biggest mistake I have done, first of all. Okay. And in that mains also, I give my time for current affairs. Almost some half of my time to attend for the current affairs. Can you see me now?
Yes.
Okay. But I didn't give enough time for optional or ethics or even for essay. So wherever, in optional in the sense, I'll go and attend the test series and I'll go and sit for a discussion and I'll get the papers done corrected. But I didn't work out for maps. It was like a sort of underconfidence and overconfidence together played. And it was my the next mistake in my mains. Okay, and my answer writing practice was actually not up to the mark. I am not able to complete the paper on time even during the test series every weekends. Okay, 1 or 2 questions I used to skip till the time of mock test time. That was the main thing, because I used to feel that I didn't complete the syllabus. Once if I complete the syllabus, I am able to answer all the questions. I didn't get enlightened that even if I complete the syllabus, I am not able to know all the answers. I need to manage at least 2 or 3 questions for every exam. Okay, that enlightenment I got when I sit in the main exam 2016. I wrote some McBride commission, some allelopathy questions came. Only that time I got realized, okay, for all these 2 questions will be, there are 1 or 2 questions in exam hall. It will give a surprise element, whether it is MAP or optional or GS. Okay, it will give surprise. Okay, but if you focus on these 2, we'll miss the other 18 questions or 20 questions. Okay, so our area is to focus on at least some 12 to 15 questions in an excellent way. This is how sir is to teach us. Target 80 and come achieve that 80%. Okay, don't bother about the 20%, because it is equally surprise to all, everyone in the exam hall. Okay, that is our next enlightenment and mistakes. And then for the time, because the transition time due to some personal problems and other problems, I couldn't come back easily. This is the main mistake we used to do. We can fail every time, but we need to come back very fast. Okay, every time we used to get failed, we used to come back very fast, but I took a much larger time during that period, almost from 4 to 6 months. So I couldn't come back. That is my next mistake. Once I come back, even now, I don't know that whether I've done perfectly this year, but maybe due to the consistency or due to the knowledge I gained all these years and some sincerity, because frankly, I'm saying you, I didn't sleep for 3 hours before the day of optional, even though I got 5 days to prepare. I mean, in between the exams, we have 5 days for optional alone, but I didn't sleep 3 hours. I slept only 2 hours perfectly, and because I couldn't able to, because I want this to be corrected harder this year, so I didn't sleep. And it took me in my paper 2, I am not able to finish the paper. That sleep has started coming and I couldn't able to finish the paper, but still I'm able to manage it. I didn't give the paper till my the room person, supervisor, forced me to give the paper. I'll not tie also in the last minute, because I did all these things in my first attempt. I know that even if they collect, they will wait. Anyhow, they will wait and tie the paper and get the paper tied. So I'll not allow. I'll just write the answers. I don't want to fail from my place. Okay, I'm very clear on that. So this is how I work, and I got into, and everything is above all, you need to be connected with your staff. Okay, you should be very clear and transparent to your staff, faculty. Only then he can able to help you in the way we can achieve the results. Okay, if okay, you are seeing you. That where, if you are not able to say or tell that where we are getting stuck, he cannot able to help us. Okay, this is how me or Manoj or even Kishore and all, we are very transparent to sir. We will say, this is the issue, these are the issues where we are get stuck in, and he will say, and next time at least some 50% we are able to correct it and we will go. Then he can help us. Okay, this person is following us, so that he will also be get interested or to guide us. Okay, and one more thing is our friends. Okay, you should be very careful and cautious about your friends. You may get confidence also, or you will feel sometimes, you know what, under confidence also with your friends. So that matters a lot. Sometimes it will help you, because whenever I used to study in study halls or somewhere around 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock, my friends write mains that time, but they used to stay me. They used to correct my few answers and all. And one of my friends, he used to drop me to the hostel, even though it is 100 meters, still he used to drop me. So these things and all, we need to be careful with our friends. Okay, fine. And at times, for optional, Yakub, Manoj, Kishore, and Gopi Anna, so all these people help me too. Even though they are also attending mains, they are also equally competitive, and we work together without any without any unhealthy competition. Okay, it was very healthy, so that we are able to see each other's views and all, and we'll sit together in front of sir to get it corrected. So this is how we are able to improve ourselves slowly. For example, Mano's intro will be very good. Maybe I have some points, or I can make up the paper with some diagrams or something. So I can give and take easily. Okay.
And one more doubt, man.
Yeah.
What was your first option? Is there any change in your option or your structure?
No. I didn't change. I before coming to civil service, I had a dilemma whether I can take my literature. I was very much interested in Tamil literature, and I was equally interested in history right from my school. So I had a dilemma, and I took history because if I miss the opportunity here, I cannot get any other opportunity to read history after this. But Tamil is not like that. Okay, literature I can still able to manage to an extent. So in that area, I compromised myself. And that time I don't know that sir is that time itself sir is very famous for history, and that time itself South India sir is the best for history optional. So I didn't know that sir is best. Just like that, I entered, and I didn't get back. I was equally happy whenever I am writing an answer. I am very happy to write an answer for history optional by making notes or something. So I never even thought of going for other options, or searching for other options. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Somebody else? Want to ask the question, please? Anybody else? I think the coordinator can check up.
Three participants raise their hands.
Who are they? You just.
So there are some questions also. Improve the quality of mains answer from Raji, and how to approach post-independence consolidation. So first, Raji. I can see you. I can see you very clearly. See, Raji, to improve the quality of mains answer, whenever we took some break and we are coming back again it starts from zero. Okay. So first, organize your thoughts how this question should be. What is this question and how am I going to answer? You don't worry about the facts. Okay. Just frame the structure on your mind. That's how this question is going to be divided. If you want to support with diagram also, just imagine on your right side, now you are okay with the diagrams and all. Okay, so just put a diagram. It's all sir's technique only, so sir will help you. To improve the answer, first write the answers. Then give to your friends. Okay, they will say some comments. Then again, write the same question. Okay. And continue the process almost daily. Write 2 to 3 questions. Continue the process for at least 1 to 2 weeks, some 15 days. Okay, some almost half of the notes you might have completed by that time. Then start focusing on the time. Okay, till the time you don't worry about the times and all. You just want to know the structure. Initially, if you're not okay with the answer, go to the internet and search for the answers and refer your notes for points to supplement and all. Okay, this is like a notes making initially, but after 2 weeks, it will be okay. Okay, then you know, taken care of the time thing and able to recollect, okay, everything. So slowly you will improve. If you're able to attack the question, this is relevance. Okay, fine. How to approach post-independence consolidation, Chitra, to be frank, I used to attend, I think Chitra, you're right. Okay. So I used to attend 2 classes. I can see you. 2 classes of sir's class. Okay. Nothing else. Even I have the notes, maybe with sir also I have the notes. During main stems, sir used to conduct the classes. If you're a history optional person, you'll have some 10 marks in the post-independence. That too for a paper 2 compulsory question. Okay. You can very well go through with the previous year questions. You are able to crack. And GS, 10 questions, 10 marks. 1 question, it may come or not come. Okay, so totally you are planning for 20 to 30 marks from post-independence consolidation. For that, you need not to spend whole time in reading the entire books and all. Just sit in the class and attend the discussion. That is more than enough. If at all you have time right now, you can go India since independence. but it is not recommended. You need to do skimming work. Okay, that is not used for history, but it can be used for economy, maybe. Okay, so I recommend not to do overwork in that area. Just attend SIRS class, that is more than enough. Okay, and that my 129 also got from SIRS class only. Okay, don't worry about that. And can you tell the failure of 4 attempts in Tamil? Because my parents are watching and they are thinking it takes 5 years to complete. Okay, this is from ZX. Sir, shall I say this question in last? Maybe?
Yeah, you answer this question in Tamil in the last. Okay, the parents are watching, I think.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah,
why you took 4 attempts? That in Tamil you can answer, okay?
Sure. And sir and ma'am, UPSC is possible for the student from rural background with less English knowledge. How many attempts it will take? I cannot guarantee with the attempts, but I'm a girl from rural background with this much English. I can able to crack UPSC and I become an IAS officer. Last year, Shivaguru Prabhakaran, he is also from rural background, government school medium. He also cracked the exam. And many of my friends who studied in government school this year also. One of my friend in Delhi, Dilkush, he's in MENA. He studied entire thing in government school. He cracked. Vikram Veerkar, who is going to Maharashtra, he cracked. So there are so many things, so many people you can crack. And I don't think you want, with the less English knowledge is sufficient. More than sufficient. If you're able to understand, I mean Nesakaran. If you're able to understand what I'm speaking now, this is more than enough. Okay, so don't worry about the language is not at all a barrier for any exams. If you are confident in Tamil, you can go and proceed the entire thing in Tamil. Okay. Sir, fees amount, I think this question is for...
Yeah, not that, somebody will call them. I think from the office, they will call and inform them. Nothing to worry.
All I can say is that you can pay for two to three attempts maximum. After that, sir will take care. It's like Nalanda University, it will become. Okay. So I don't think maybe for, you know, he will ask some cost. That's it. Okay. I have written mains in 2013. Didn't get through it. Group 2 service timing. Okay. Okay, see, for working people, I'm saying that will you able to get at least 1 hour in the morning and 1 hour in the evening? Okay, just even now you people are busy due to the corona works and all. I'm saying that whether if you are able to get one hour, maybe you are married, you have kids and exit, everything will be there. Or early morning, some around 4 to 5 or 5 to 6, you are able to cash that as well and go down somewhere. And if you are getting some extra time in office, that is your bonus time. Okay, don't worry about it. And evening before bed, try to get one hour. Okay, if you start like morning 1 hour and evening 1 hour, fix the timing and don't compromise the time. 1 hour, initially 2 hours for you. And then don't involve yourselves in, too much of work in office. Don't worry, even if they say on your face, you're not doing any work, you're not performer, everything, whatever they say, don't worry about that. Okay. So you just focus on the preparation. Saturdays and Sundays, you should get the hours in your hand. Okay, be clear in that. So for 1 hour, 1 hour, if you start preparing, start from the NCRT. Start from the zero. Okay, morning, study the NCRT. Taking history optional. Study right from the 6th standard NCRT. And again, in the evening, just revise it. Okay. Initially, it will be good for you. Go slow. Don't compare your timings with the full-timers. No, full-time preparation people timings, okay? And don't compare your performance with them. Okay, you have some limited time. So, if you're consistent in your preparation, I mean, 1 hour or 2 hours, 2 hours, or how much... where you're able to spend, go and go relaxedly and don't compare yourself with any other people, you will get it done. Okay, not today or tomorrow, but maybe in 1 year or 2 years, you will get it done. Okay. And economic survey, I'll tell you, I think economic survey, don't worry. For prelims, it may or may not come. If it comes, one question or two questions. And mains, you can use the 4 points whenever you want. Okay, I think now we can strict ourselves to history optional. Okay, then Madhubala, ma'am. Old NCERTs first. Okay, new NCERTs, you can fit it to the folder points. Okay, because old NCERTs are better, and if you use it for revision and all, it will be very good for analysis aspect, and straight away use it for mains. If you read, for example, Bipin Chandra, even the first chapter, if you read it again and again, you will find how you can shape your answers for mains. GS questions straight. Okay, straight. Okay. Is there any other one? Historians, yeah, you can quote. Okay. Historians, don't worry. Quote it whenever it is required, but don't inject any historians artificially. Okay, whenever it comes with a flow, if they are differing the opinion, for example, Marxist historians or environmental historians or feminist historians, you can say it as in a natural way in your answers. Okay, but don't interrupt or you know what, don't try to say that you know much more than the examiner. Okay, it will irritate them. Okay, so don't try to say or project like that. Otherwise, you can very well use for sources, you can use, or you can use in the Indus Valley or something, you can use it. Okay, Labasna experience is must, everyone should get experienced. It's like again going back to college, but with more strict and tight schedules initially, and then with a full of opportunities and opening new areas to us, and yeah, it's a good place also, Mussoorie, you should experience. Okay, we'll discuss that in a separate video. Okay, don't worry. I wish you all to be in Labasna on some other day. Okay. Current affairs preparation. See, current affairs preparation, you can start with your Hindu. You can stick to any one online material, whatever the online material you are reading. One newspaper, one online material, and one class. Class, I can say that it is must. Shivraj sir class is must for current affairs, because when you are nearing the prelims, you will conduct some online class for exclusive prelims class, current affairs. Okay. If you read that current affairs material alone, 40% of the current affairs question straight from that book, that material. Okay. It's a straight question. You can take from, you can, even I can show from 2015, I can able to say that, okay, these questions are from these areas in this page, particular page in the book. Okay, 40% straight. Just three times you need to revise the book apart from attending the class. And above all, you need to take your own notes in Hindu or something, and your own online, one online. Okay, that's all. Don't see Ross, and don't see Vajiram, and don't go to Insights, don't go to Vision, don't get confused, and don't, current affairs will eat your lot of time. Okay, stick anyone, whichever you are following, that's fine. Okay, I started GK today, and Shivraj sir class must, and Hindu, initial days I started with PIB also. Okay, whichever you are following, go with that. Okay. Is there any other things? So Rajendran sir is also here.
Yeah. I'm just seeing this, I don't know. I'm not seeing his face also. Where is it?
It's clear.
Yeah. I think he's watching from his house with his kids.
Somewhere outside, okay.
Yeah, future AS. Yeah, you can answer the question in Tamil. Somebody has asked, no?
Uh-huh, yes, sir.
You answer the question. Meantime, if some other question comes, you will answer that also later.
Sure, sir. நாலு அட்டம்ப்ட் எனக்கு வந்ததுக்கு ரீசன் முதல்ல வந்துட்டு நான் சேர்ந்த டைமிங் ஆகஸ்ட்ல 2014 எக்ஸாமுக்கு நான் வந்து ஏப்ரல்ல போய் ஜாயின் பண்ணேன் படிக்காம ஸோ அதனால என்னோட ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அட்டம்ப்ட் வந்துட்டு ஒரு டேர் அட்டம்ப்ட் மாதிரி இப்போ காலேஜ்ல எல்லாம் படிக்காம யூனிவர்சிட்டி எக்ஸாம் எழுதுற மாதிரி எழுதுனதோட எஃபெக்ட் அது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அட்டம்ப்ட் அது வந்து அப்படி போயிடுச்சு அப்போ நான் வந்து ஆப்ஷனல் கிளாஸ்க்கும் போல மெயின்ஸ் கிளாஸ் கூட நான் அட்டன் பண்ண கிடையாது கூட முடிக்காம தான் நான் அதை போய் கொடுத்தேன் சொல்ல போனா வந்து நெகட்டிவ் மார்க்கிங்கோட அவேர்னஸ் கூட இல்லாம தான் நான் அந்த அட்டம் கொடுத்தேன் ஓகே ஸோ அதுக்கப்புறம் ஒரு 2-3 months ஆகிடும் நம்ம ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வந்து ஒரு ஃபெயிலியர் பாக்குறோம் அப்படின்னா வந்து கொஞ்சம் அப்படி வெளியே வர்றதுக்குலாம் கொஞ்சம் லேட் ஆகும் ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி ஆச்சு திருப்பி வந்து ஒரு திருப்பி உட்காரும் போது என்னாச்சுன்னா ஒரு ஒரு சின்ன பயம் இருக்கும் ஃபுல்லா படிக்கணும் படிச்சு எல்லாத்தையும் படிச்சு முடிச்சுக்கணும் அந்த பாட்டி அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு ஊர்ல சொன்ன எல்லா மெட்டீரியலையும் படிக்க ஆரம்பிச்சேன் எல்லா மெட்டீரியலும்னா ஃபார் நான் அதான் சொல்லல கரண்ட் அஃபேர்ஸ்னா நான் ஹிந்து படிப்பேன் பிஏபி படிப்பேன் அப்புறம் ஜிபி பார்ப்பேன் அப்புறம் இன்சைட்ஸ் பார்ப்பேன் இப்படி பார்த்துட்டு இருந்தா கரண்ட் அஃபேர்ஸ்க்கு எனக்கு டைம் ஆயிடும் ஒரு சில டைம் பேப்பரையும் வச்சுட்டு ஒரு 7 மணி நேரம் அந்த மாதிரிலாம் ஓட்டியிருக்கேன் ஓகே ஸோ எவ்வளோ நேரம் ஒரு சப்ஜெக்ட் கொடுக்கணும் அப்படின்றதே தெரியாம நான் கொடுத்துட்டே இருந்தேன் ஓகே அண்ட் அப்பயும் வந்துட்டு ஸ்மார்ட்ல வந்துட்டு டெஸ்ட் சீரீஸ் டஃபாக தான் இருக்கும் அந்த டெஸ்ட் சீரீஸ்ல வந்து நமக்கு ஒரு 90 or 100 வந்தா ஓகே அப்படின்னு சொன்னா நமக்கு 70s 80s இருந்துட்டே இருக்கும் ஓகே பட் சிவராஜ் சார் சொல்லுவாரு சாதிக் சார் வந்து அந்த ஃபார்முலா சொல்ல மாட்டாரு சிவராஜ் சார் தெளிவா சொல்லுவாரு ஸ்மார்டஸ்ட் பிளஸ் 40 அதாமா உங்க மார்க் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிடுவாரு ஓகே ஆனா சாதிக் சார் சொல்ல மாட்டாரு ப்ரெடிக்ஷன்ஸும் கொடுக்க மாட்டாரு எப்பயுமே ஓகே எழுதிருக்கியா மெயின்ஸ் படி அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாரு ஓகே அப்ப என்ன பண்ண செகண்ட் அட்டெம்ப்ட்லனா 15ல வந்து பேட்டர்ன் எல்லாம் சேஞ்ச் ஆகுது நமக்கு ஒரு மைண்ட் செட் வந்து 80 questions மேல அட்டன் பண்ணக்கூடாது அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு எக்ஸாம் போறதுக்கு முன்னாடி நான் செட் ஆகி போயிட்டேன் அங்க போனா க்வெஸ்சன் பேப்பர் ஈஸியா இருக்கு அப்போ வெளியே வந்ததுக்கு அப்புறம் நான் வந்து 80 questions தான் அட்டன் பண்ணும் சொல்லிட்டு 80 அட்டன் பண்ணி ஒரு க்வெஸ்சன் வந்து நானோ டெக்னாலஜி க்வெஸ்சன் அதை தெரிஞ்சு நான் வந்து மார்க் பண்ணும்போது ஓஎம்ஆர்ல மார்க் பண்ணும்போது டீப் போட்டேன் திருப்பி செக் பண்ணும்போது பார்த்தா தெரியும் உங்ககிட்ட ஒரு ஒயிட்னர் கேட்கலாம் எரேசர் கேட்கலாம் அப்படின்னு கூட இல்லை எப்படினாலும் ஒரு 90 அந்த மாதிரிதான் எல்லாரும் எல்லா யூனிவர்சிட்டிஸும் ஜி இந்த வாட்ஸ்அப் யூனிவர்சிட்டிஸ் இந்த எக்ஸாம்ஸ் எல்லாம் சொல்றாங்களா அவங்க எல்லாம் ப்ரெடிக்ஷன்ஸ் எல்லாம் எப்படி சொல்றாங்க ஒரு 90 to 100 பிசி அந்த மாதிரி என்ன அப்படின்னு சொன்னாங்க நமக்கு தான் வந்து 80 இருக்கே 60 questions கரெக்ட் ஆனாலும் நம்ம உள்ள போயிடுமே அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு அந்த க்வெஸ்சனை பண்ணாம இருந்தது இதெல்லாம் வந்து என்னோட ஆட்டிடியூட் பிரச்சனை ஓகே ப்ரீ ஃபிக்ஸ்டா போனது attitude issue-னால அந்த question கரெக்ட் பண்ணாம இருக்கு அந்த வெர்டி வந்து 105 வந்து OBC கட் ஆஃப் நான் வந்து 103.75 ஓகே அந்த ஒரு question கரெக்டா இருந்தா 2 marks plus அந்த நெகட்டிவ் marks minus இருந்தா கரெக்ட் அது clear-ஆ இருக்கும் ஓகே அந்த ஒரு mistake-னால நான் திருப்பி ஒரு 1 year உட்கார்ந்தேன் என் friends எல்லாம் exam முடிச்சிட்டு வெளிய வந்தே கேட்டா எல்லாரும் வந்து 90 questions attend பண்ண 95 attend பண்ண அந்த மாதிரி சொல்லிருப்பாங்க because easy ஆகுதா கஷ்டமா இருக்குதான்னு நமக்கு exam hall போனா தான் தெரியும் அது வரைக்கும் நம்ம எந்த ப்ரீசெட் நோஷன்ஸோட போனோம்னா நமக்கு தான் பிரச்சனை ஓவோ அங்கே போய் உங்களுக்கு உங்களுக்கு ஈஸினா ஊரில் இருக்க எல்லாருக்கும் ஈஸி உங்களுக்கு டஃப்னா ஊரில் இருக்க எல்லாருக்கும் டஃப் ஓகே ஸோ அதுதான் ரூல் அந்த 2 மணி நேரத்தை நம்ம பெஸ்ட்டாக முடிச்சுட்டு வரணும் கிளாஸ் டீச்சப்பே சார் சொல்லுவார் 1 மணி நேரத்தில் முடிச்சு நீங்கள் என்ன பண்ண போறீங்க 2 மணி நேரத்தையும் யூஸ் பண்ணுங்க அப்போ தான் வந்துட்டு அந்த எலிமினேஷன் டெக்னிக் இல்லை 50% இருக்கிறதுக்கெல்லாம் ஒர்க் அவுட் பண்ண முடியுமா ஒர்க் அவுட் பண்ண முடியுமான்னு தெரியும் ஸோ இதுதான் இதுதான் வந்து செகண்ட் அட்டெம்ப்ட்ல நான் பண்ணது ஆனா செகண்ட் அட்டெம்ப்ட் முடிச்சோடனே ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அட்டெம்ப்ட் இந்த மாதிரி நான் ஓடல ஓகே ஸோ அப்போ முடிச்சுட்டு நான் சாயந்தரம் சொன்னேன் நாட் டூ வருது சார் அப்படின்னு சாயிக் சார் போட்டு சொன்னேன் அப்போ வந்துட்டு சார் என்ன சொன்னாருன்னா ஜஸ்ட் லைக் ஹேங்கிங் ஆன் த வால் தான் பட் நீங்க போயிட்டு வாங்க பார்த்துட்டு வாங்க ஊருக்கு போயிட்டு வாங்க அப்படின்னு சொன்னாரு பட் ரிசல்ட் வந்து ஒரு ஊருக்கெல்லாம் போயிட்டு வந்துட்டேன் வந்ததுக்கு அப்புறமும் தெரிஞ்சு ரிசல்ட் வரல அப்படின்னு ஷாக்கு பயங்கர ஷோக் ஏன்னா 90-95 அந்த மாதிரி சொன்னாங்க நம்ம 102 வச்சிருந்தோம் வரலையே அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு தென் என்ன பண்ணனா சார்கிட்ட சொன்னேன் இல்லை சார் நான் எனக்கு ஒரே ஒரு நாள் நான் பிரேக் எடுத்துக்கிறேன் என்ன பண்ண போறீங்க அப்படின்னு கேட்டாரு சாதிக் சார் ஃபோன்ல தான் என்ன சார் நேரில் பாக்குறது கூட நமக்கு அந்த ஒரு கில்ட் இருக்கும் இல்லையா நம்ம அடிச்சு சொன்னோம் கான்ஃபிடண்டா சொன்னோம் நமக்கு வரல அப்படின் போது ஸோ அதனால ஃபோன்ல தான் சொன்னேன் சார் இந்த மாதிரி வரல அப்படின்னா சார் என்னமா அடுத்த பிளான் என்ன ஒரு ஒரு 2 நாள் சார் நான் ரெஸ்ட் எடுத்துட்டு வரேன் அவ்வளோதான் திருப்பி பார்ப்பேன் இந்த வாட்டி கண்டிப்பாக ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் கிளியர் பண்ணும் அப்படின்னு பிளான் பண்ணேன் அந்த டைம் வந்துட்டு பக்கத்தில் ஒரு TNPSC எக்ஸாம் தான் அடுத்து வந்துச்சு ஸோ இந்த டிப்ரெஷன்ஸ் எல்லாமே ஒரு பாசிட்டிவாக திரும்புறதுக்கு எனக்கு அது ஹெல்ப் பண்ணுச்சு கையில் அடுத்து என்ன இருக்கோ அதுதான் அப்பா எனக்கு அப்பாவும் சொல்லுவாங்க அடுத்து இப்போ முடிஞ்சிச்சா ஓகே நெக்ஸ்ட் கையில் என்ன இருக்கோ அதை ஃபோக்கஸ் பண்ணுங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாங்க ஸோ என் கையில் நெக்ஸ்ட் இருந்தது 2 விஷயம் ஒன்று ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் TNPSC குரூப் 1 ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் இது 2 தான் என் கையில் இருந்துச்சு ஸோ குரூப் 1 ப்ரிலிம்ஸ்க்கு ஃபோக்கஸ் பண்ணேன் முடிச்சேன் முடிச்சுட்டு வந்து நான் ஆப்ஷனல் ஜாயின் பண்ணிக்கிறேன் சார் அப்படின்னு சொன்னேன் பட் என்ன திருப்பி நான் டெஸ்ட் சீரீஸ் எல்லாம் இருந்தேன் நான் அதை அப்படியே கண்டினியூ பண்ணும் அப்படின்னு நினச்சேன் ஸோ அதனால அப்படி சொன்னேன் பட் என்னாச்சுன்னா அந்த ஃப்ளட்டு அந்த அதர் இஷ்யூஸ் எல்லாம் வந்ததுனால நான் வீட்டுக்கு போக வேண்டியதாக இருந்துச்சு ஒரு 3 மந்த்ஸ் நான் வீட்டில் தான் இருந்தேன் மாற்றி அப்பாவுக்கு அம்மாக்கெல்லாம் உடம்பு சரி இல்லாமல் போயிட்டு இருந்துச்சு பட் அங்கேருந்தும் நான் வந்து ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணேன் கையில் என்ன புக்ஸ் வச்சுருந்தோனோ அதை வச்சு பண்ணேன் ஊருக்கு பேப்பர்லாம் வராது பேப்பர் வந்து தினகரன் இந்த மாதிரி பேப்பர் தான் வரும் திண்டுலாம் வராது ஸோ லேப்ல உட்காந்து அந்த நியூஸ் பேப்பர் அப்படின்னு போட்டோம்னா சப்ஸ்கிரைப் கூட பண்ண கிடையாது 2 days நியூஸ் பேப்பர்னு போட்டோம்னா வரும் அப்புறம் கொஞ்சம் கொஞ்சமாக நீங்கள் அந்த காலையில் ஒரு 1 hour நமக்குன்னு ஒரு 4 to 6 ஏதோ ஒரு 1 hour உட்காந்து படிக்க ஆரம்பிச்சேன் அப்படி படிக்க ஆரம்பிச்சு கொஞ்சம் டைம் கிடச்சிச்சு ஓகே நம்ம ஓரளவுக்காவது ஃபார்மில் இருக்கோம் அப்படின்னு தெரிஞ்சிச்சு நம்ம போக முடியும் திருப்பி போனதுக்கப்புறம் ஆக்சுவலி ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் டைம் வந்துச்சு நான் திரும்ப போகும்போது ஜான் ஃபெப் அந்த மாதிரி வந்துச்சு பட் இருந்தாலும் சர்டிஃபிகேட்டை வெள்ளிக்கிழமையோ புதன்கிழமையோ உட்காந்து டெஸ்ட் சீரிஸ் போட்டு ஹாஸ்டல் எழுதிட்டே இருப்பேன். அப்ப எனக்கு தெரியும் கண்டிப்பா நான் இந்த வாட்டி ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் கிளியர் பண்ண போறேன்னு. ஏன்னா ரெண்டு வருஷமா போட்ட எஃபர்ட்ல எனக்கு தெரிஞ்சிச்சு இந்த வாட்டி ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் பிரச்சனையே இல்லைன்னு. ஆனாலும் ப்ரிலிம்ஸ்க்கு எஃபர்ட் போட்டேன், ஏன்னா எனக்கு வந்து பார்டர்ல இருக்கக்கூடாது அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு ரொம்ப எஃபர்ட் போட்டேன். அதோட இது வந்துட்டு அந்த டைம் நியர் டு ஃபாரஸ்ட் கட் ஆஃப் சம் 110 அனுபவம் நினைக்கிறேன் ஓபிசி. அந்த டைம் 126 அனுபவம் சம்திங் எடுத்தேன். ஓகே ஓசி கட் ஆஃப் எல்லாத்தையும் கிளியர் பண்ணிட்டேன். ஆனா வந்து மெயின்ஸ்க்கு நான் ரெடி ஆகல. ஓகே மெயின்ஸ்க்கு எப்ப அந்த ஒரு பதட்டம் தெரியுதுன்னா ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் எக்ஸாம் முடிச்சுட்டு அடுத்த நாள். ஓகே அப்போ சார் சொன்னார் ஒரு 1 week போயிட்டு வாங்க, எக்ஸாம் முடிக்கும் போதே எனக்கு தெரியும் இது கண்டிப்பா வந்துடும். நான் அதே மாதிரி ஒவ்வொரு வாட்டியும் எவாலுவேஷன் அதாவது மார்க் வந்து நம்ம பார்ப்போம்ல செக் பண்ணுவோம், கீ செக் பண்ணும்போது எனக்கு வந்துட்டு ஒரு மார்க் அரை மார்க் எக்ஸ்ட்ராவா தான் வருமே தவிர நான் ப்ரெடிக்ட் பண்ண குறையாது. ரெண்டு இன்ஸ்டியூட்டுக்கு மேல நான் வந்து கீ செக் பண்ண மாட்டேன், 90% ஸ்மார்ட் தான் செக் பண்ணுவேன்.
ஹலோ கேக்குதாப்பா? அம்மா கேக்குதா?
ஹலோ இங்க மான்சூன் ஸ்டார்ட் ஆயிடுச்சு சார், அதனால என் சைடுல தான் கொஞ்சம் நெட்வொர்க் இஷ்யூ.
சரி சரி பண்ணுங்க, நீங்க பேசுங்க, நீங்க பேசுங்கம்மா.
மெயின்ஸ்க்கு ப்ரிப்பேர் ஆகல, அதோட பிரச்சனை வந்துட்டு எப்ப எனக்கு புரிய ஆரம்பிச்சதுன்னா. எஸ் சார் கேன் யூ ஹியர் மீ சார்?
மா கேக்குது கேக்குது, கொஞ்சம் இதா இருக்குது, பரவாயில்லை பேசுங்க முடிச்சிருங்க.
ஓகே சோ ஒரு ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் முடிச்சு ஒரு 1 week நல்லா ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸோட சுத்திட்டு வந்தேன். அந்த ஃபீவர் இருக்குன்னு கூட தெரியல, ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் அப்ப ஏதோ ஒரு ஃபீவர்லாம் இருக்கு, அதெல்லாம் முடிச்சிட்டு வந்ததுக்கு அப்புறம் தான் தெரியும். எழுதும் போதே தெரியும் கண்டிப்பா கிளியர் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு முடிச்சுட்டு வந்தேன். 1 week கழிச்சு வந்ததுக்கு அப்புறம் தான் ப்ரிப்பேர் ஆகலன்னே தெரியும். அப்பவும் மெயின்ஸ் டெஸ்ட் சீரீஸ்ல ஒரு 5 க்வெஸ்சன் நல்லா இருக்கும், 20 questions. ஏதோ அந்த அந்த நேரத்துல மூடு நல்லா இருந்திருக்கும், எனக்கு இப்படி தூக்கி போடல பேப்பரு. அவர் சொன்னாரு நீ ஜிமிக்ஸ் பண்ணா மூடுதான் இந்த வாட்டி எஸ்ஏல வந்து கொஞ்சம் தேர்வு ரொம்ப கம்மியா இருக்கு, ஜிஎஸ் ஆன்சர் கூட ரொம்ப மட்டமா இருக்கு அப்படின்னு சொன்னாரு. அது அடுத்து ஒரு பயம் கொடுக்க ஆரம்பிச்சிச்சு. ஓகே நம்ம நம்ம வந்து ஒர்க் அவுட் பண்ணியிருந்தோம்னா நம்ம கான்ஃபிடன்ஸ் வந்துட்டு இம்ப்ரூவ் ஆகும், அதுதான் நான் ப்ரிலிம்ஸ்ல பண்ணேன், எனக்கு அந்த கான்ஃபிடன்ஸ் கொடுத்துச்சு. நான் மெயின்ஸ்ல ஒர்க் அவுட்டே பண்ணல, அது வந்து எனக்கு இருந்த கான்ஃபிடன்ஸ் அப்படியே இறக்குச்சு. ஓகே எக்ஸாம் ஹாலுக்கு போகும்போது நமக்கு எல்லாமே தெரிஞ்சிருக்கணும் தெரிஞ்சிருக்கணும்னு நினைப்போம். அந்த எல்லாமே தெரிஞ்சிருக்கணும், படிச்சிருந்தோம்னா நமக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும் இப்படி நினைச்சவரோட பிரச்சனை. பிகாஸ் நான் அப்பவும் வெளியே அங்கிங்கன்னு எதுவும் போகணும், கிளாஸ் ரெகுலராக அட்டன் அதான் சொல்றேன். கரண்ட் அஃபேர்ஸ் நான் நிறைய டைம் ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்ணானதை ஆப்ஷனல்கோ இல்லை மற்ற ஜிஎஸ்கோ ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்ணல. ஒரு சார் சொல்லுவாரு எல்லாத்துக்குமே ஈக்குவலாக கொடுங்க, 500 மார்க்குக்கு எவ்வளோ டைம் கொடுக்கணுமோ அவ்வளோதான் கொடுக்கணும், 1000 மார்க்குக்கு எவ்வளோ டைம் கொடுக்கணுமோ அவ்வளோ டைம் நம்ம கொடுக்கணும். அதை பேலன்ஸ் பண்ணலை. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டே வந்துட்டு கொஞ்சமாவது ஒரு பார்ட் நான் ரெடியாக வச்சிருந்தேன், ஆப்ஷன் வந்து கிளாஸ் போனேன் டெஸ்ட் சீரியஸ் பண்ண அவ்வளோதான். அதுக்கப்புறம் நான் திருப்பி ரிவிஷனோ இல்லை திரும்ப திரும்ப அதை படிக்கவோ இல்லை. இந்த பிரச்சனையெல்லாம் இங்கே எனக்கு வந்து அடிக்க ஆரம்பிச்சிச்சு. அதுக்கப்புறம் மேப் அப்படின்னாலே வந்து நம்ம பண்ணலையே நம்மளா ஓனா எஃபர்ட் போடலையே அதுலேயே ஒரு பதட்டம். ஓகே ஸோ இது எல்லாம் சேர்த்து எக்ஸாம் ஹாலில் வந்துட்டு நமக்கு கொடுக்க வேண்டியது கொடுத்துச்சு. ஐ மீன் எங்கே கொஞ்சம் ஒர்க் பண்ணணும் அங்கெல்லாம் எனக்கு கொடுத்துச்சு, எங்கே நான் ஒர்க் பண்ணலையோ அதெல்லாம் எனக்கு எப்படி சொல்றது ரொம்ப கம்மி பண்ணிடுச்சு. சுமார எஸ்ஏ வந்து ஒரு ஒரு 10 எஸ்ஏ ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ணிருக்கவங்க கூட அந்த வந்து 150 to 160 எடுத்திருப்பாங்க, நல்லா பண்ணிருக்கவங்க 160 எடுத்திருந்தாங்க. ஓகே பட் எனக்கு வந்து 114 தான் வந்துச்சு, அந்த டைம் 3 மார்க்ல கம்மி போனது நல்லா ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கோங்க. ஸோ கொஞ்சம் ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ணியிருந்தா இந்தந்த ஏரியாலாம் ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ணிருக்கணும் அப்படின்னு பார்த்தது. பட் அதுக்குள்ள என்னாச்சுன்னா உடனே ஒரு 10-20 நாள்ல நெக்ஸ்ட் ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் வருது. ஏற்கனவே சொல்லி இந்த கொஞ்சம் வீட்டில் பர்சனல் இஷ்யூஸ்லாம் இருந்துச்சு அப்படின்னு சொன்னேன். ஸோ பர்சனல் இஷ்யூஸ் அப்படின்னா அப்பா ஒரு பக்கம் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல் இருக்காங்க. ஓகே ஸோ நமக்கு வந்து இந்த அட்டம்ஸ் எல்லாம் போயிடுச்சு, வீட்டில் இன்னொருத்தவங்க வந்துட்டு ஹவுஸ் ஹஸ்பண்ட் முடிக்கிறாங்க. ஸோ நிறைய ப்ரெஷர்ஸ் இருக்கும், சுற்றி இருக்கவங்க எல்லாம் நமக்கு ஒரு கல்யாண டார்ச்சர் கொடுப்பாங்க ஊருக்கு போனால் இந்த மாதிரி எக்கச்சக்க பிரச்சனை எல்லாம் இருக்கும். ஆனா அதெல்லாம் தலைக்குள்ள போட்டுக்கிட்டதுனால தான் என்னோட பெரிய பிரச்சனை. தலைக்குள்ள போடாம இருந்ததுன்னா பிரச்சனையே இல்லை. இப்ப அது எதுவுமே பிரச்சனை இல்லை. அப்ப வந்து அதெல்லாம் தலைக்குள்ள போட்டது. சோ அது வித்தின் 18 டேஸ்ல ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் வரவும் நான் அதுக்கு ரெடி ஆகல. மைண்ட் லெவலாகவும் சரி இல்ல என்னோட ஸ்டைல்லையும் நான் ரெடி ஆகல. நான் எப்பவும் போல என்னோட ரிவிஷன்ஸோ என்னோட மெத்தட்ஸோ ஃபாலோ பண்ணாம அப்ப அந்த நேரம்னு பார்த்து நான் குரூப் ஸ்டடிஸ் உட்கார ஆரம்பிச்சிட்டேன். தனியா இருந்தா போய் அழுதுருவேன். அதனால வந்துட்டு குரூப்பா வந்துட்டு எனக்கு உட்கார வச்சிருப்பாங்க ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். பட் குரூப்பா உட்காந்தோடனே என்ன ஆயிடுச்சுனா அவங்க எல்லாம் என்ன படிக்கிறாங்களோ அதை தான் நான் படிச்சேன். கடைசி 10 நாளைக்கு எனக்கு என்ன ஸ்ட்ரென்த் என்னோட வீக்னஸ் என்னன்னு சொல்லிட்டு அந்த கடைசி என்ன நம்ம அந்த 1 வருஷமா நம்ம திருப்பி ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் ரிவிஷன் பண்ணல. அப்படியே ஒரு ஃப்ளோல போயிட்டு இருந்தோம். ஓகே திருப்பி வந்து 10 நாளுக்குள்ள ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் பண்ணோம்னா கடைசி லாஸ்ட் மினிட் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி நமக்கு ஒன்று வேணும். நமக்கு ஸ்ட்ரென்த்தா இருக்கிற ஏரியால நமக்கு கொஞ்சம் கான்சன்ட்ரேஷன் இருந்தா போதும். ஓகே நமக்கு கொஞ்சம் சயின்ஸ்லாம் எனக்கு கொஞ்சம் வீக் அப்படின்னா நான் அது கொஞ்சம் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா எஃபோர்ட் பண்ணுவோம். கரண்ட் அஃபேர்ஸ் வந்துட்டு கொஞ்ச நாள் பார்க்காம இருந்திருக்கேன். ஸோ அதெல்லாம் மறுபடியும் நம்ம போட்டிருக்கோம். ஆனா அதுக்கு பதிலாக குரூப்பா உட்காந்து அவங்க என்னென்னலாம் படிக்கிறோம் ஜஸ்ட்
ஹலோ ஹலோ ஆ இப்போ அவங்க திடீர்னு ஒரு ஃபோன் காலுக்கு எமர்ஜென்சி போயிருக்காங்க. இப்போ கேக்குதா ஆடிபிள்? யா அம்மா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் நீங்க அந்த க்வெஸ்சன் கேட்றீங்கமா குணா சம் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் தேர் நோ?
யா குட் ஈவினிங் சார்.
அம்மா சொல்லுங்க.
எனக்கு வந்து கேன் யூ ஹியர் அபௌட்
சொல்லுங்க ஜஸ்ட் நீங்க க்வெஸ்சன் கேட்றீங்க. யூ ஆஸ்க் தி க்வெஸ்சன் நல் வி ஆஸ்க் தர்மனா டு ஆன்சர்.
ஹவ் டு அப்ரோச் அன் க்வெஸ்சன் இன் தி ப்ரிலிம்ஸ்? There are some questions like neither nor type and something like only type. How to approach it?
Ma, adhu namba enna namma first answering the preliminary questions is it requires lot of some issues to understand. Okay, UPSC is framing questions in different formats. Okay, there will be questions which 1 2 3 1 only 2 only 1 and 2 only like this combination. There will be something which is called A and B, A correct, B correct, A and B, B and C like this. This we will discuss later because this can't be discussed in 5-10 minutes. We have to take some question. First, we have to understand the concept. Then only we can discuss the question. So what I will take this question in some other session where I will explain to you one area. I will teach you one area. Then I will frame a question in that area. Then I will tell you how to answer that question. Okay.
Yes, sir.
First, I will teach that area. One area I will take, one small area. I will teach you for 5-10 minutes. Then I will put a question. Then I will answer the question based on how the UPSC will be framing the question. That I will answer, Maguna. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let we'll ask Dharmala to complete that. Amma? Dharmala, you finish. Mudichirunga. Vantingla.
Okay, okay, okay. Sorry, sir. Actually, quarantine ala food avangala veliya vachiruvanga.
No problem, no problem.
I haven't strict quarantine. Avanga kelambiduvanga, so adanalae they need to force me to open.
Okay, okay.
So, second thing, idu vandu idella na panna mistakes and then come back aga marubadi vandu late aachu enakku. Okay, again, fourth attempt. நல்ல ஒரு நல்ல வரைக்கும் போயிட்டோம்னா கீழே விழுந்தா ரொம்ப வலிக்கும். ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி கொஞ்சம் டைம் ஆச்சு. தட் டைம் எனக்கு ஒரு 3 பேர் ரொம்ப வந்துட்டு கூட இருந்தது அப்படின்னா அப்பா ஃபுல் சப்போர்ட் இருந்துச்சு அந்த டைம். அதுக்கப்புறம் வந்துட்டு சார். ஓகே செகண்ட் பிகாஸ் என்டையர் ப்ரிப்பரேஷன் அப்படின்னா எனக்கு நான் எல்லாத்திட்டையும் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ்டே எல்லாம் சொல்லுவேன் நான் ஏபிசிடிலேருந்து பிஹெச்டி வரைக்கும் எனக்கு சொல்லணும் அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவேன். ஸோ த சேம் திங். ஸோ அதனால பிடிச்சி வச்சிருந்தாரு சார். அண்ட் தென் என்னோட ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் இன்க்ளூடிங் மை சிஸ்டர். ஸோ இவங்க எல்லாரும் சேர்ந்து தான் வந்துட்டு அப்படியே என்னைய ஒரு எப்படி சொல்றதுன்னா ஒரு டேக்ல வச்சிருந்தாங்க. ஓகே யூ கேன் டூ பிகாஸ் யூ ப்ரூவ் 3 மார்க்ஸ் தானே யூ கேன் அப்படின்னு சொன்னாங்க. ஸ்மார்ட்ல அப்படின்னு சொல்லணும்னா என்டையர் இன்ஸ்டியூட்டே எனக்கு வந்து அப்படியே எப்படி சொல்றதுன்னா ஒரு ஒரு இன்வால்வ் மாதிரி எல்லாருமே ஹெல்ப் பண்ணாங்க. ரைட் ஃப்ரம் ரிசப்ஷன்ல ஒரு அக்கா இருப்பாங்க அபிதா அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு அந்த மேம்ல இருந்து ஒரு அக்கா டீ போட்டு கொடுப்பாங்க பழனியமாக்கு. ஸோ எல்லாருமே ஹெல்ப் பண்ண ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க. இட்ஸ் நியர் மிஸ் அப்படின்னு தெரியும் நமக்கே தெரியும். நியர் மிஸ் அப்படிங்கும் போது வி ஆர் ஹைலி எலிஜிபிள் டு பி இன் தட் லிஸ்ட் அப்படின்னு நமக்கே ஒரு கான்ஃபிடன்ஸ் வரும். ஓகே ஸோ அப்போ அந்த கான்ஃபிடன்ஸ் வரும்போது கண்டிப்பாக அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு திரும்பவும் நியர் மிஸ்ல போய் மாட்டக்கூடாதுன்றதுல நம்ம ரொம்ப தெளிவாக இருப்போம். பட் இப்போ நான் ஒரு மிஸ்டேக் பண்ணது என்னன்னா எங்கெங்கெல்லாம் விட்டனோ அங்கே மட்டும் கான்சன்ட்ரேட் பண்ணிட்டேன். ஸோ ஐ நோ தட் எத்திக்ஸ் இஸ் மை ஏரியா மேப் ஆப்ஷன்லாம் இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் பண்ணிருக்கணும் என் கையில் இருந்த மார்க். ஏன்னா பேப்பர் 2ல 140 அப்படின்னா தாராளமாக அந்த டைமே நான் 280 எடுத்துருக்க முடியும். அப்பவே என் கையில வந்து நான் கொஞ்சம் அதாவது ஒரு பிளான் மட்டும் கரெக்டா வந்து 70-80 மார்க்ஸ் எடுத்துருக்க முடியும் அப்படின்னு தோணுச்சு. வந்துச்சு. ஓகே பட் இதுல என்ன தப்பு பண்ணனா எங்கெல்லாம் ஸ்ட்ராங்கா இருந்தோம்னா அங்கெல்லாம் ஃபோக்கஸ் பண்ணவே இல்லை. ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் GS1 அங்க எனக்கு வந்து 30 மார்க் இறக்கி விட்டுருச்சு. ஓகே ஃபோக்கஸ் பண்ணல ஏன்னா எனக்கு வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம் வந்து நான் நல்லா பண்ணிட்டேன் அப்படின்னு ஒரு ஒரு ஓவர் கான்ஃபிடன்ஸ் வந்துச்சாங்க தேவையில்லை அதோட டைம் எடுத்து நான் ஆப்ஷனல் கொடுக்குறேன் நான் எத்திக்ஸ் கொடுக்குறேன் எஸ்ஏ கொடுக்குறேன் கொடுத்ததுல ஒரு பிரச்சனை நீங்க வந்து இன்டர்வியூக்கு வந்து அந்த டைம் எனக்கு நல்லா வந்தது இந்த டைம் அதுல ஒரு 20 மார்க்ஸ் கம்மி ஓகே ஸோ அதுவும் என்னன்னா சரியா ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணல இன்டர்வியூக்கு நம்ம வந்து ஓகே இன்டென்ஷன் ஓகே பட் ஆனா கன்விக்ஷன் பாயிண்ட் பை பாயிண்ட் அவங்க கேட்குற க்வெஸ்சனுக்கு கன்விக்ஷன் வித் லாஜிக் ஓகே அதை வச்சு நம்ம வந்து நம்ம ஒப்பீனியன் வந்து அவங்களுக்கு ஜஸ்டிஃபை பண்ணணும் அது தெரியல ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இந்த வாட்டி போகும்போதே வந்துட்டு போகும்போதே முரணா தான் இருந்தது அவருக்கும் எனக்கும் ஸோ அங்கிருந்தே அது செட் ஆகல லாஸ்ட் டைம் அதே முரண் எனக்கும் அவங்களுக்கும் இருந்துச்சு பட் தே அப்ரிஷியேட்டட் மீ வெரி வெல் ஓகே இந்த பொன்மகள் படத்துல கடைசி ஒரு டைலாக் இருக்கலாம் அந்த டைலாக் நான் அப்பவே இன்டர்வியூல அதை தான் சொன்னேன் எனக்கும் என் பக்கத்துல இருக்கவருக்கும் சண்டையோ கூட கிட்டத்தட்ட சண்டை மாதிரி வந்துச்சு பட் சேர்மன் வாஸ் வெரி அப்ரிஷியேட்டிவ் சேம் டைலாக் தான் சொன்னேன் குட் டச் பேட் டச் எத்தனை வாட்டி சொல்லி கொடுத்துட்டு போறீங்க இப்படியே தான் நான் கேட்டேன் ஓகே பட் இட் ஆல் டிபெண்ட்ஸ் பட் உங்களால வந்துட்டு இன்டர்வியூவை எப்படி சொல்றது நல்லா கொஞ்சம் ஹெல்ப் பண்ணியிருந்தோம் ஒரு 200 போயிருக்கும் பட் அது வந்துட்டு என்னோட 180 இருந்து 160 கம்மி ஆயிடுச்சு புரியுதா ஒரு ரொம்ப சர்வசாதாரணமா 40 மார்க் கம்மி பண்ணிடுச்சு அதுல ஓகே சோ இதுதான் என்னோட லெசன்ஸ் ஆக்சுவலி பாண்டியராஜன் ஏதோ சொல்றாரு
ஆமா யாரோ ஒருத்தர் கை somebody is raising the hand மா யார் பாண்டியராஜன் சொல்லுங்கப்பா
பாண்டியராஜன்
யா கேளுங்கப்பா
ஆ மேம்
சொல்லுங்க
மேம் இது மெயின்ஸ் எக்ஸாம் பத்தி கொஞ்சம் கன்ஃபியூஸா இருக்கு மேம் அதை பத்தி கொஞ்சம் ஃபுல் டீடைல் மட்டும் சொல்லுங்க மேம் ஆப்ஷனல் பேப்பர் அப்புறம் இந்த எத்திக்ஸ் பேப்பர் அண்ட் அதர் பேப்பர் அப்புறம் இந்த ஹிஸ்டரியில வந்து ஹிஸ்டரியில வந்து என்னென்ன வந்து ஃபோக்கஸ் பண்ணணும் அதை பத்தி கொஞ்சம்
மறுபடியும் ஒரு வாட்டி சொல்றீங்களா எனக்கு சரியா புரியல
மேம் மெயின்ஸ் சொன்னீங்களா மேம் எஸ்ஐ பேப்பர் எத்திக்ஸ் பேப்பர் ஆப்ஷனல் பேப்பர் மேம் அதை பத்தி கொஞ்சம் டீடைல் கொஞ்சம் கன்ஃபியூஸா இருக்கு மேம் அதை பத்தி கொஞ்சம் டீடைலா கொஞ்சம் சொல்லுங்க மேம் ஹிஸ்டரியில வந்து என்னென்ன ஃபோக்கஸ் பண்ணி படிக்கணும் அதை பத்தி கொஞ்சம்
நீங்க ஹிஸ்டரி ஆப்ஷனல்னால மெயின்ஸ் வந்து எப்படி மார்க் எடுக்க முடியும்ன்றதை டீடைலா கேக்குறீங்களா
எஸ் மேம்
ஓகே ஓகே அண்ட் ஹிஸ்டரி ஆப்ஷனலுக்கு என்னென்னலாம் படிக்கணும் அப்படின்னு கேக்குறீங்களா
எஸ் மேம் எது எது அதிகமாக ஃபோக்கஸ் பண்ணணும்
ஓகே ஓகே மியூட் பண்ணிக்கோங்க ஐ வில் சே ஓகே ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம் வந்துட்டு நீங்க டைரக்டா அதாவது மாடர்ன் இந்தியா அண்ட் வேர்ல்ட் ஹிஸ்டரி வந்துட்டு ஸ்ட்ரைட்டாவே க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் வரும் ஜிஎஸ் ஒன்னுக்கு ஸ்ட்ரைட் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸா வரும் ப்ரீவியஸ் இயர் ஆப்ஷனல் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் படிச்சீங்கனாலே அதுக்கு ஆன்சர் பண்ண முடியும் ஆனா ஆன்சர் வந்துட்டு எப்படி சொல்றேன்னா இதெல்லாம் வந்துட்டு எக்ஸ்பெக்டட் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் அப்போ இதுக்கு ஆன்சர்ஸ் வந்துட்டு 90% இருக்கும் 90% ரெலவென்ட் இருக்கும் ஸோ அது அப்படியே சார் நோட்ஸ்ல இருந்து நீங்க எடுத்து அங்க போட்டீங்கனாலே போதும் ஓகே ஆனா அதுக்குன்னு சொல்லிட்டு இந்த க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் ஓவர் டூ பண்ணிடாதீங்க மிச்ச க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ்ல அது அடி வாங்கும் ஸோ இது ஒண்ணு அடுத்தது ஜிஎஸ் டூக்கு அப்படின்னா டைரக்டா உங்களுக்கு யூஸ் ஆகுமானா டைரக்டா யூஸ் ஆகாது ஐ மீன் டைரக்டானா அப்படியே கேட்பாங்களா அப்படின்னா இருக்காது பட் நீங்க கத்துக்கிட்டது அந்த வேர்ல்ட் ஹிஸ்டரியில இருந்த ஆஸ்பெக்ட்ஸ் எடுத்துட்டு கொண்டு வந்து இங்க போட முடியும் இன்ட்ரடக்ஷன்ஸ்லயோ கன்க்ளூஷன்ஸ்லயோ நீங்க போட முடியும் ஓகே அதுக்கப்புறம் கவர்னன்ஸ் அஸ்பெக்ட்ஸ்ல இது எப்படி எல்லாம் வந்துச்சு அப்படின்னு போட முடியும் சோஷியல் கான்ட்ராக்ட் எடுத்துட்டு வந்து நீங்க இதுல யூஸ் பண்ண முடியும் ஓகே இந்த மாதிரி பாயிண்ட்ஸ் எடுத்துட்டு வந்து நீங்க ஸ்ட்ரைட்டா வந்துட்டு பேப்பர் டூல போட முடியும் பேப்பர் த்ரீ வந்துட்டு போஸ்ட் இண்டிபெண்டன்ஸ் ஏரா நல்லாவே யூஸ் ஆகும் இன்டர்னல் செக்யூரிட்டில இருந்து எக்கனாமிக்ஸ்ல இருந்து ஏன் வந்துட்டு அந்த லேண்ட் சீலிங் அதுக்கப்புறம் லேண்ட் ரீஆர்கனைசேஷன் ஸ்டேட் ரீஆர்கனைசேஷன்ஸ் இது எல்லாமே வந்துட்டு உங்களுக்கு அங்க ஹெல்ப் பண்ணும் ஸ்ட்ரெயிட்டா அப்படின்னா ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் எல்லாம் எதுவுமே இருக்காது பட் இது இதை படிச்சீங்கன்னா அந்த அந்த பாயிண்ட்ஸ் எல்லாமே வந்து ரிலவென்ட் பாயிண்ட்ஸ் அங்கே கன்வெர்ட் ஆகும் ஓகே அண்ட் தென் எத்திக்ஸ் வந்துட்டு ஸ்கூல்ஸ்னு இருக்கும் ஸ்கூல்ஸ் ஆஃப் தாட்ஸ் இருக்கும் இந்தியன் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் மாடர்ன் ஃபிலாசபர்ஸ் எல்லாம் இருப்பாங்க ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் காந்தியை நம்ம சொல்லுவோம் நாராயணகுரு சொல்லுவோம் ஈவன் செல்ஃப் ரெஸ்பெக்ட்
ஹலோ கேக்குதா திருபலா
எது வரைக்கும் சார் கேட்டுச்சு
நாராயண குரு அதை பத்தி பேசிட்டு இருந்தீங்க
ஓகே தென் இட் வாஸ் ஃப்ளோ ஸோ 2-3 க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ்க்கு நீங்க வந்துட்டு எத்திக்ஸ்ல ஸ்ட்ரைட்டா ஆன்சர் பண்ண முடியும் 7 பிரின்சிபல்ஸ் ஆஃப் காந்தி 7 சின்ஸ் ஆஃப் காந்தி தான் கேட்டிருந்தாங்க ஒரு டைம் அப்படியே ஸ்ட்ரைட் க்வெஸ்சன் ஓகே அண்ட் தென் காந்தி அண்ட் அம்பேத்கர் பத்தி ஐ மீன் அவங்களோட பிரின்சிபல்ஸ் பத்தி ஒரு டைம் questions vandhathu ethics la okay and caste vachi or questions varu women vachi or questions varu appa adukkela neenga eduthu eduthu idu podalam unga kitta sonna the quotes and the points ellathayum eduthu neenga appadi adula podalam okay then essay la vandu neenga unga structure vandu romba alaga varanumna inga irundhu pogum history la irundhu neenga aarambichinga unga essay romba alaga varum ஒரு இன்சிடென்ட்ட சொல்லும் போது ஹிஸ்டரியிலும் இப்படிதான் இருந்துச்சு இது புதுசு இல்ல அப்படின்னு நீங்க எடுத்து சொல்றதுக்கும் இல்ல வந்து ஹிஸ்டரியில இந்த மாதிரியான விஷயங்கள் நடந்துச்சு அப்படின்னு சொல்றதுக்கும் இல்ல ஹிஸ்டாரிக்கலா நீங்க ஒரு எஸ்டே ஒரு குரோனாலஜில இருந்தா இப்போ ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் நீங்க ஒரு டிஃபென்ஸோ இல்ல ஒரு பியூரோக்ரசி பத்தி கேக்குறாங்க அப்படின்னா நீங்க சாணக்கியா சொன்னதுல இருந்து நீங்க எடுத்து எழுதலாம் அங்கெல்லாம் நமக்கு ஒரு வெயிட்டேஜ் வரும் ஒரு எஸ்டே வந்து ஒரு ப்ராப்பரா மாறிக்கிட்டே வரும் நமக்கு தெரியாம ஓகே திருப்பி இதுக்கு எக்ஸ்ட்ராவா என்ன படிக்கணும் அப்படின்னா நான் அது சொல்லுவேன் கிளாஸ் நோட்ஸ் என்சிஆர்டி அது இல்லாம இவர் கொடுக்குற சார் கொடுக்குற மெட்டீரியல்ஸ் டெஸ்ட் டிஸ்கஷன்ஸ் ப்ராப்பரா இருக்கும் ரிவிஷன்ஸ் அட்டன் பண்ணணும் திரும்ப திரும்ப இதை பண்ணா போதும் இது தாண்டி எக்ஸ்ட்ராவா எதுவுமே பண்ணவே வேணாம் ஓகே வாங்கி வச்சும் அது வேஸ்ட் தான் புக்ஸ் எல்லாம் அவர் சார் சொல்லிட்டு இருப்பாரு உங்களால தான் இந்த புக்கு கடைக்காரங்களாம் வாழ்றாங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாரு ஒரே ஒரு புக் நான் வாங்குறதுக்கே அப்படி திட்டு வாங்கியிருக்கேன் பாத்துக்கோங்க புக்ஸ் தேவை அவ்வளவுக்கு நீங்க வெளியே புக்ஸே வேண்டாம் அது அது பண்ண பண்ண எப்படி இருக்கும்னா உங்களுக்கு வாங்கி ஒரு பக்கம் அடிக்கிட்டே இருக்க ஐயோ இது நம்ம முடிக்கலையே முடிக்கலன்ட்டு ஒரு பக்கம் இருப்போம் இது முடிச்சிருந்தோம்னா நம்ம ஒருவேளை நல்லா எழுதிருப்போம் அப்படின்னு நினைப்போம் ரெண்டுமே நடக்காது ஓகே எக்ஸாமுக்கு என்ன தேவையோ அதை பண்ணுங்க நாலேஜுக்கு தேவையானதெல்லாம் நீங்க ஃப்ரீ ஆயிட்டு அதுக்கப்புறம் படிங்க ஓகே இப்போ ஒரு ரெண்டு புக் நான் கையில வச்சிருக்கேன் பாதி படிச்சிருக்கேன் இ காப்பி ரெண்டு புக் வச்சிருக்கேன் வேல்பாரி காவல் கோட்டம் இதெல்லாம் படிச்சுட்டு தான் இருக்கேன் ஓகே ஸோ பின்னாடி படிக்கலாம் டைம் இருக்கானா எங்கேயாவது ஒரு இடத்துல நமக்கு டைம் கிடைக்கும் டிராவல் அப்போ அங்கே எங்கேயும் எப்படியாவது டைம் கிடைக்கும் அது நாலேஜ்க்கு படிக்கிறது வேற எக்ஸாம் கிளியர் பண்ணுறதுக்கு என்ன வேணுமோ அதை மட்டும் பாருங்க ஓகே
சரிம்மா நம்ம என்ன பண்ணலாம் சி வாட் வி கேன் டூ ஆடிபிள் எவ்ரிபடி இஸ் இட் ஆடிபிள் ஓகே சி ஐ திங்க் ஃபார் மெனி பீப்புள் தி செல்போன் அண்ட் சார்ஜ் அதர் திங்ஸ் ஆர் கெட்டிங் ஓவர் Okay, so one by one, people, even my battery is getting coming to an end. So, nice. We'll just take up our last question. Okay, so 2-3 people are raising their hand, but I think...
two participants. I think they can type the questions.
Yeah, you type the questions. For Kishan and Nesa Karna. You type the questions if possible. Just we'll answer very briefly, okay? Uh-huh. Kishan, you want to ask the question directly? Who is the Kishan?
Kishan is there. Kishan, Soundarya or something.
Ask the question briefly. We'll answer it briefly because I think many of the students, they are not able to continue because of the cell phone and other network issues, I think. Okay.
Kishan, I think you can, sir, you can unmute him, sir, Kishan.
Where is Kishan? I'm not able to see that.
This person has to unmute. I think he needs to unmute.
Yeah, Kishan.
Hello.
Yeah, Kishan, speak.
Sir, madam, regarding current affairs, you said one material. During that time, I have faced some net issue. I can't hear.
Nothing. You read Hindu or the newspaper which you are reading regularly. Because I read GK today for online thing because that time there was no other online material. Okay, but you go with the flow. Whatever you are reading, you just follow it. Don't do 2-3.
Okay.
Don't refer 2-3 online materials, whatever you're reading. And third one, I used to attend Sivaraj's class here in smart offline class.
Okay.
To know whether what I'm doing is proper or not. Okay. So these three are more than sufficient.
Okay, man. Thank you.
Okay. Next, Nesa. Some Nesa Karan.
Soundarya also, some waving, sir. Rice panel. Just a video la raise pandranga
just Nesakaran somebody
yeah, Nesakaran
I don't know whether
we can ask Soundarya just unmute Soundarya yourself
unmute and ask the question please
hello
yeah go ahead Soundarya
yeah hello akka actually ungalku irunda adhe doubt da enakku irukku nanu tamil literature da vandu eduthirken ipo but vandu history edukanonra oru innoru option innoru side irukku ana tamil la vandu konjam confident konjam adhigama irukku edhu konjam better irukku ungalku irunda adhe konjam confusion da irukku
Okay. Is there anything else?
Illa, all welcome.
Okay, okay. Just mute and ask. See, with respect to dilemmas in taking optional, first think whether you are interested in the particular subject. Okay, for her condition is she is interested in both, like me, Tamil and as well as literature versus history. And now you need to know, just go through the syllabus first. Don't worry about the marks in market. Okay, it may vary, it may not vary, don't bother about. First, you know whether you are liking it or not, and go through the syllabus. Third one, whether you have a proper mentor to guide you. In the interest, subject interest, we will go in our own way. Okay, we'll get one book after one book, and we'll go in a wrong direction and maybe misguided also. Whether you need to understand this, whether you have a proper mentor to guide you only towards this UPSC direction, not to become a subject expert. Okay, so ensure that and follow. Fine. So that's what I'm saying. He used to sit with us one to one. I'll get an answer right from my handwriting, sir, used to change. Okay, and whether I can incorporate, slowly I develop my content and then slowly I incorporated facts and figures on sidelines, innovations in the answers and all. So it's like a process. We cannot get it in a single day. For Rajalakshmi also, I'm saying, for mains answer you asked, it's not you can get it in a one day. It will go as per your flow. Depends upon my speed and my orientation, sir, will change. Okay, so you need to compare whether you have you are getting the same for Tamil and you are getting for the same for history, and take a call. But don't come back and don't get regret. Okay, you have taken a wrong one, or if you could have taken Tamil, you could have get too much of high marks, or if you could have taken history, you could have taken high marks. Don't regret about anything. Okay, all options have their own positives and as well as cons. Okay. Sir, one more Nesa Karana, something?
Yeah. Nesa Karana just asked a question, I think, no? Nesa Karana.
Yeah, he asked a question.
Sir, madam?
Ah, solanga po.
Madam, I have read Tamil newspaper, madam. Mm-hmm. And I used to say, you know, Hindu paper, that's an English paper, but you know, Ramaniki, sir. I'll park him with the
Confused in this process. English paper, Tamil paper, nothing. If they put it in the English paper, in 1 or 2 days, it will be translated the same ditto. For example, Holy Kavana, Punitha Pasu, Apriya translate pani, they will put it on the Tamil paper. Okay. Oh. So don't worry about the language. See, first, clear about which medium you are going to write, whether you are regional medium or in the English medium.
Okay.
Fix that. And focus on those papers. Only then you will get the accurate words for some English words. Okay. For example, plasticna negildi ni irukumla. So andmari Tamil words ungalku you want to get it for put it in your answers. So go with that paper, and you need to know whether you are able to grasp what the author is trying to say. Okay. This is the first observation from newspaper. Second one is that even though their opinion is biased or not, whether you are getting some facts for your UPSC. Okay.
Okay.
It's not there, don't read that article.
Oh, okay,
ma'am. Don't read that article. Ignore that article, or you can put whatever designs you want to put it in your paper. Go to the next article and finish it off. Don't take more than 2 hours for completing the newspaper.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. See, okay, 2018 bye. Prelims being the toughest, how did you... Sir, last questions. We'll finish with this question. See, are the tougher, easier, we cannot know when we are writing. Okay, all we need to prepare is we need to prepare ourselves for the worst. Okay, we should learn everything. I mean, we need to revise the NCERTs again and again. We need to do some 10,000 MCQs or test batch. Yeah, some 3,000 to 4,000 MCQs from test batch itself, and you can work out the previous year questions. So almost some 10,000 questions you might have been worked out for MCQ practice, I'm saying. In that, you know how to attempt the question, how to do negative, your max probability, you can work it out. Okay, how much you can work it out, and how can you eliminate everything. Okay, and next thing is about revision. Pakka revision. I mean, current affairs and all, you need to revise it 3 to 4 times, you need to revise it. And I used to revise smart test paper, question papers, almost the last month. Okay, 1 month or 1.5 months, I'll keep only for the question papers. I'll revise the question papers because we used to make so many hints along the sides of the notes, or I'll put one or two notes for that. Okay, I'll revise the questions, and that will go to the concepts. Small concepts. If we don't know, we'll go back again. And culture and map, that time it is must. Okay. But we do not know whether that year is EC or that year is a history optional, a history question paper year or a polity paper year or geography year. We don't know anything. We need to get prepared for the worst. We need to subject all the areas. We need to attempt all the areas. And then in the exam hall, all we need to do is try to give our maximum. Okay. If you are confident, you are able to cross 80, cross 90, go. If you are not confident, sila peripanga. Okay, few people, like, they will attempt 70, and in 70 also 65, they will get it correct. Which sort of person you need to know. Okay, whether it is a tough or easy, we cannot predict that time. Okay, all I know that time during my exam hall is that it is history paper. Okay, and even though it is history, being history optional for 3 to 4 years, I was wrong in 2 or 3 history questions. I am sure. I know that. Okay, that's all I know. But with you'll have one area which is your core area. I have one area which is my area. So in that max, it may be tough for everyone, or easy for all. Okay, ultimately we need to clear problems. That is our main thing. Okay, with respect to last YouTube page, see, whenever I am getting, I am able to see and able to reply. But be specific to your questions in YouTube also. Okay, fine, that's it, sir.
Okay, ma. See, I think it's already almost 2 hours. Okay, so most of the people are running out of their
tired
battery. Yeah, you are already tired. So nice meeting you all. So I am going to conduct a session. Okay, free session. Live session on the 6th morning, I'm going to conduct this session. Okay. 6th morning, we'll conduct this session. So you please attend. I'll start the class on the 6th morning. 2 days, I'm going to conduct this session on this 6th, 7th, 2 days, I will conduct this session. So I think you can all attend this session, and I will teach a topic. I'll explain to you how the questions are asked, how you will answer in the mains, that and all I will speak. Okay. So that's what I will do you. So I think we thank Ms. Dharmala for spending her time. Okay. So anytime you have any doubt in history is concerned, also you can call her and ask her. Okay. We'll arrange somehow when she is coming to Chennai. I'll ensure that she will come and meet you all. Okay. Secondly,
we'll try to meet.
Yeah. And also, if you want to note down my personal phone number, those people who are, you can note my personal phone number also, but just WhatsApp. Okay, if I can't pick up, just WhatsApp. Okay, so my phone number is 7299.
Sir, you can actually type in the chat box.
Yeah, somebody is typing that. Okay, 7299 71 7767. Just WhatsApp me. Okay, if you have any doubt, you WhatsApp me. Okay, then if you have time, you can speak. So thanks all of you for coming. It's nice interacting with you all. I thank Dharmala again also. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. We'll meet you all. Thank you. I think we'll end this session. Thank you. All the best. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you. All the best. Take care. Thanks.